I think we're like 343 or something like that, with about 20.8 fouls per game this season. Upwards of 22.4, I believe, something like that, in the Atlantic 10 play. That's got to change. I mean, it's tough for teams to score in the half court on us, but we're you know, giving up 34 free throws the other night, 22 in the second half. I'm not so sure that we really fouled that much, or if we did, that they didn't foul the same. But, I mean, the reality is we've got to do a better job of guarding our men, staying in front, force tough contested twos, because when we do that, we don't put guys on the line. We're pretty tough on the defensive end, and that's what we got to get back to.
And when you look at the KenPom numbers for this Loyola team, you see a top 55 defense in the nation. Drew Valentine has built a team that's really effective, really efficient on the defensive end. When you watch the tape of this Loyola defense, what has led to those efficient KenPom numbers?
Just tough, nasty. They remind me of a team like very similar to us last year. You know, they got a great defensive shot blocker in the freshman, really tough four-man in Alston, like similar to Khalid Moore. You know, they got a great offensive, you know, five-man that comes off the bench that, you know, obviously had 41 at one point last year at Dartmouth. You know, reminds me a little bit of like Rostick and Abdu combination from last year. And then their guards are older. I mean, you got a fifth-year guy or a senior in Alston who's played the Atlanta 10, who's really improved dramatically. Obviously, sixth year in Norris playing and started for a Final Four team. Guys that come off, like Greg Dolan coming off the bench, is a fifth-year guy, led Cornell in scoring last year. So a much older, experienced group that play tough and physical. They crash the offensive glass. So, you know, that's just they play hard. They play hard, so...
This time last year, there were games where this gym was packed to the brim, and the team benefited as a result of that energy. Could this be the type of matchup that reinvigorates the fan base in one way or another?
Yeah, I hope that's a problem that we have to reinvigorate, right? Right there, that using that word is an issue when you're trying to build something and trying to do something really special for years to come, right? And you're not always going to be top one or two team or an NCAA tournament team. I mean, everybody goes through it, right? But we're trying to do something here that's really sustainable. And in order to do that, you have to have a home court advantage. The other night, we had a great showing. Need them to be more energized, louder. I mean, you look at the tweets and things of that nature from last year. This place, standing room only. Entire student section standing the entire 40 minutes. You know, whiteouts, the shirtless herd, the energy, how loud it was. It was infectious, you know, and that rattles some cages when you do it for 40 minutes. Guys don't step up on the line and go 12 for 12 from the free throw line like Reed Bailey when he had been struggling up until the point where he gets steps in the gym. So it's just something that we need a little bit more consistent. We need to play better and play more consistent on the basketball court, 94-50, but we need some consistency from the fan base as well. Not fan base, but more so the student body.
Coach, as always, thank you so much for your time. Good luck tomorrow.
Go Rams.
Welcome back inside Rose Hill Gym. It's the Fordham Rams and the Loyola Chicago Ramblers. Ramblers in their road maroons moving left to right. Fordham Rams in their home whites moving right to left. Abdu Sambila in the center circle with Miles Rubin. Abdu taps it back to Will Richardson. And the Fordham Rams have the first possession of the day. Here's Ramad Dean, top of the circle. He gets clamored. It'll be the foul on the floor to get us underway. So let's take a look at those Fordham Rams starting lineups. Jafe Madore is out today. He sprained the ankle. He's in a boot, and he will not play. So Will Richardson, your starting point guard. Antrell Charlton, Kyle Rose, your starting backcourt. And then Ramad Dean gets his first career start as a Fordham Ram, and Abdu Sambila wraps up the starting five. Here's Ramad Dean, first offensive possession of the day. Hands off for the curling Kyle Rose. Rose works his way in. Kicks it back up top for Antrell Charlton. He can't hit the three, but Ramad Dean, the offensive rebound. Here's Kyle Rose. Left corner, dribble drive, the left-hand finish. Off the left side of the window and down. It's a 2-0 start for Fordham. 35 seconds in.
A good start for Fordham. A possibility that was made by Ramad Dean off the offensive glass. A good offensive board for him. Way to make an entrance.
Here's Braden Norris, the veteran point guard. Knee-high dribble with the left hand. Takes the Reuben Miles screen, top of the circle. Chest pass over to the shooting guard, Dawson Leftarc. He dribbles into the lane, flips it high post, and the pass is picked off by Abdu Sambila. Antrell Charlton ahead to Ramad Dean. He'll have the lay, and he'll scoop it home with the right hand. 4-0 Fordham, a minute and 7 seconds in.
Miles in the span of 30 seconds, a great offensive board from Dean. Then he hustles on the ensuing possession, gets a fast break bucket. Fordham with a 4-0 lead, running and gunning early on.
Here's the full court pressure. One man from Kyle Rose in on the point guard, Braden Norris. Norris crosses the timeline, finds Dawson top of the circle. Dawson angles his way to the left elbow, restarts top of the key, flips it over to Dez Watson. Watson finds the center, Reuben Miles. Miles backs his way in, center of the paint, in on the much smaller Kyle Rose, short with the left-hand finish, and Kyle Rose the rebound ahead to Will Richardson the other way. 4-0 Fordham, 18-15 first half. Here's Richardson, dumps it down low for Abdou Simbila. He gets fouled. This will be on the floor, 18-10 first half. It's a 4-0 start for Fordham, and that'll be the foul on the floor. Let's take a look now at those Loyola Chicago starting lineups. Braden Norris, the veteran point guard, a pure shooter and a polished guard, followed by Jaden Dawson and Dez Watson in the backcourt, Philip Austin, the senior forward, and Miles Reuben, the freshman, 6'10" center down low. Here's Abdou Simbila backing his way down, hard of the paint now. Here's the whistle, and they call the travel. Dragged his feet as he rose, and he turns it over with 18:01 to play first half. It's 4-0 Fordham, Loyola Chicago ball.
Abdou Simbila called for the travel. It's been an offensive struggle for him this year, averaging 9.2 points per game. Fordham was hoping he'd give them a little bit more production in that department, but he's certainly grown during his time here in the Bronx.
So Adel Kuhn, the sixth man, checks on. Dribble drive in on Abdou, and he rises with the righty hook, and it falls off glass. Loyola Chicago onto the board now. It's 4-2 Fordham. Here's Kyle Rose, flips high post for Antrell Charlton. Knee-high dribble with the left hand, crosses over top of the key on Dez Watson. Charlton, some contact on the right arc. He'll flip it up top for Ahmad Dean. Fakes the three, finds Kyle Rose on the left arc. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Kyle Rose, dribble drive the left side, finds Abdou Simbila. Left block, back in his back to the basket, rises with the left hand, and he cannot finish. Well short there. And Dame Adel Kuhn rips down the Loyola Chicago rebound.
Aggressive play from Adel Kuhn. Abdou Simbila outmanned there by a much bigger defender.
And Dez Watson draws some contact from Ramad Dean on the floor. That'll be Ramad Dean's first of the day. That'll stop the clock with 17:09 to play first half. It's 4-2 Fordham in a real defensive slugfest early, but Loyola Chicago basketball near sideline inbound. Dez Watson flips it into Braden Norris at the top of the circle. Gets it back to a shooting guard in Dawson. Finds the sixth man in Adel Kuhn. Spins in on Abdou once again. Left block now, backing his way in on Abdou. Works his way into the paint. Rises with the right. And he's well short off the left side of the iron there. And Kyle Rose rips it down.
A nice job by Simbila to keep in front of Adel Kuhn. Got a hand in his face and contested the shot.
Kyle Rose dribbles between the legs, angles his way to the left elbow, flips it down low for Abdou, and Abdou will draw some contact on the floor. This one's on Braden Norris in a real mouse-in-the-house situation there. The 6-foot point guard, Braden Norris, got caught down low and had to commit the foul on Abdou Simbila. It's 4-2 Fordham Rams, 16:41 to play first half. It'll be the offensive baseline inbound for the Rams and their home whites.
And Miles, that's the type of offensive mismatch Fordham is hoping to create more of today, especially without their main point guard Jafe Madur initiating.
So Ahmad Dean getting his first career start, flips it into Will Richardson on the baseline. High post, here's Kyle Rose now in on the point guard, Braden Norris. Rose looking to go to work. He's got his pocket picked on the double team by Philip Austin. Jaden Dawson comes down with the loose ball for Loyola, and they'll go the other way. Here's transition, Austin, top of the key, three, no good off the left side of the iron. Offensive rebound, he'll keep it right here. Here's Braden Norris, top of the circle, flips it to Adel Kuhn on the right elbow. Now back to Dawson. On the right arc, down low for Adel Kuhn, right side, short corner, in on Abdou Simbila. 6 seconds on the shot clock, back to the basket once again, rises with the left hand and scoops it home. Four all here, 4 minutes in, and Will Richardson to walk it up now.
Charlton's a tough defender, but that time Loyola Chicago gets the mismatch. Fordham not able to provide an answer.
15:53 and ticking. Here's Kyle Rose, top of the circle, dribbles behind the back and flips it out to Antrell Charlton, top of the circle. Now Will Richardson takes the pass on the left arc, finds Elijah Gray, left arc, dribble drive the left side, the scoop, and it falls high off the window and down. Fordham back on top, 6-4.
Nothing too complex there from Elijah Gray. Just a nice job beating his man, making one move and getting to the bucket.
Here's Braden Norris, the undersized point guard at the 15-foot mark. Bounces it down low for Adelku. And once again, back his way down on Kyle Rose. Finds Des Watson, right arc triple. No good. Off the left side. And Dame Adelku, too aggressive, going for the rebound. He'll be whistled for the over the back. And that'll stop the clock. 15-18 to play in the first half. It is 6-4 Fordham Rams, and that will take us to our under 16 media timeout. You're listening to Fordham Rams men's basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hey everybody, I'm Lou Orlando.
And I'm Brian Rabax. We're your two broadcasters for the 2023 Fordham football season.
Follow along as CJ Montez, MJ Wright, and James Conway look to lead Joe Conlon's Rams to a Patriot League title.
You can listen to us all season long on 90.7 FM and WFUVsports.org.
WFUV Sports, the flagship station for Fordham football.
And welcome back inside the comforts of the Rose Hill Gym here in the Bronx, New York. It is 6-4. Your Fordham Rams lead the visiting Loyola Chicago Ramblers. But we're now going to turn to the third member of our crew, our sideline reporter, Dan Bartels.
Miles, thank you. You could tell sitting behind that bench, Fordham really loves the play from Abdu Sembila thus far. No points to his name, but three rebounds and a steal. It's clear what they are trying to do. They're trying to attack the perimeter. But again, Coach Ergo loves the play that he is seeing out of Sembila right now.
Absolutely. Great point there, Dan. Thank you for the update. It's 6-4 Fordham. And Abdu Sembila, the last couple games, he's battled foul trouble. Early in the year, he was a double-double machine, not so much as of late. And they're going to need a very consistent 40 minutes out of him this afternoon to compete against a tough, physical Loyola Chicago team.
Miles, even seniors can go through growing pains. Abdu Sembila is someone that Coach Ergo has repeatedly said wants to become a better offensive player. That's something that takes time, especially as a big man. When you are a center at the collegiate level, you're typically more concerned about grabbing rebounds, being able to supply some blocks. He's been great in those categories this year, leads the team with 7.6 rebounds and 43 blocks in the season. The offensive component of his game is something that's going to have to be a work in progress for now.
That's a great point. So back underway here from Rose Hill. Will Richardson to walk it up. Waist-high dribble with the left hand. Elijah Gray finds the basketball top of the circle. Hands off with the curling and Trell Charlton kicks right arc. Here's Amir Tripp. The three-pointer airballs it well left there. Elijah Gray keeps it in bounds with a right-hand save, but right into the hands there of Greg Dolan. The seventh man in now for Loyola Chicago. Loyola Chicago now to walk it up. Here's Braden Norris. 6-4 Fordham Rams. 15 minutes to play. Top of the key, here's Greg Dolan. Flips it right arc for the center, Miles Rubin. Rubin hands off for Jaden Dawson, the shooting guard. Dawson probes at the top of the circle. Dribble drive right past Rivera there in the scoop. My goodness, he beat his man. 6-6 now, 14 and a half to play, first half.
Dawson with a nice move to the bucket. Struggled last time out against UMass. Only had 7 points on a 2-of-6 clip.
Here's Jameer Tripp, the dribble drive from the right side, and a tough finish with the right hand. Right past another freshman in Miles Rubin. Gets Fordham right back on top. It's 8-6 Rams. 14-11 in ticking first half. Miles Rubin, the 6'10" freshman center, dribbles waist high at the top of the key, flips it near side, and Jaden Dawson can't handle the pass. Will Richardson the other way, kicks near side. It's Antrell Charlton, the dribble drive, and the scoop lay through the contact. 10-6 Fordham Rams with a chance for one more for the veteran, Antrell Charlton at the free throw line.
And Charlton with the attitude after the basket. When you reflect on this Fordham team, it's clear that they have a lot of guys who want to play physically, but Antrell Charlton is the sort of guy that plays with a swagger that Fordham needs at this time in the season. 2-2 in conference play. Having someone like an Antrell Charlton can work wonders for your team from a morale standpoint. A big bucket there with an emphatic motion afterwards.
And Antrell Charlton, the senior guard, known to be a leader around the program, leads by example when it comes to effort. No good off the back of the heel there. He's just a 67%er in that category. So the lead holds for Fordham at 10-6. Here's the point guard, Braden Norris, top of the circle, raises horns in the air over Will Richardson. Back to the basket on the block out, getting harassed by Will Richardson. He dribbles knee high with the left hand. Waiting to start the possession, now 10 seconds on the shot clock. Finds a teammate on the left arc. Here's Mwamba. Mwamba hands out for the curling Greg Dolan. Dolan top of the circle. He'll pull the three and no good off the front of the iron there. But Des Watson, the offensive rebound, and he draws contact from Elijah Gray. And Gray a little too emphatic there. Once again close to drawing a technical foul. But Des Watson will head to the free throw line. The junior guard, 6'5" out of Columbus, Ohio. And the clock will stop at 13:24 to play first half. It's 10-6 Fordham Rams. Two shots for Loyola Chicago.
Watson, 6'5", 210 pounds. He's a physical player, a Davidson transfer, very familiar with the A-10. Averaged 9.4 points and 41% clip from the field last year with the Wildcats.
So the first one is good out of the right hand of Des Watson, and you're exactly right, Colin. A real impact transfer for this Loyola Chicago team. They were just making their A-10 debut last year, transferring over from the Missouri Valley Conference. And Des Watson, in his first year with the program, has made a big difference in year two of the A-10 era of Loyola Chicago, coming over from a fellow A-10 foe in Davidson.
And he's been very good with the Ramblers this season, second in terms of points per game on the team, shooting 42% from the field, just under 40% from range, Miles.
So a 2-of-2 trip has it 10-8 Fordham Rams. Josh Rivera has it left side mid post, pulls it back, 15 seconds on the shot clock. Low post entry for Abdu. He'll pull the jumper. No good off the right side of the iron. We saw him practicing those yesterday, those mid-range J's, but he can't capitalize there. It's 10-8. Fordham Rams on top. Loyola Chicago the other way. Here's Braden Norris left arc in on Jameer Tripp. Norris top of the circle, flips it back to Watson. Dribble drive from Watson. He lost his footing, and Abdu Simbila the steal the other way. Ahead to Will Richardson on the right arc now. 12:40 and ticking in the first half. Richardson right side short corner. Look to draw the contact and he can't get the call. The out of control shot and the rebound for Loyola Chicago. Here's Braden Norris top of the circle. Fakes the three and flips it left side now. Here's Greg Dolan. Hands off back to Norris. Flips it near side to Mwambe. Mwambe right arc. Thought about the three on Kyle Rose. Now back it in and basket. It'll be the offensive foul. Lowered the shoulder. Driving in on Kyle Rose. And the Fordham Rams force a turnover with 12:17 to play in the first half. It's 10-8 Fordham with the basketball.
That's a veteran play from Kyle Rose. I don't know if people understand how hard it is to take a charging foul like that from a bigger offensive player. Kyle Rose was good against Davidson. 8 points, 4 assists, 6 rebounds last time out. But truly, that Bonaventure game showed you exactly who this young man is. He was excellent in that one. 19 points, dealt with some sickness during the game. It really was a testament to who he is as a person and a player.
And a leader through and through. Here's Antrell Charlton to walk it up. Hands off for the freshman, Jameer Tripp. Flips it high post. Here's Kyle Rose. Spins around on Jaden Dawson, high post. Rose probes, fakes the two-hand jump shot at the top of the circle. Back to Jameer Tripp at the top of the key, dribbling between the legs. Now just 10 seconds on the shot clock. Jameer Tripp drives in, finds Josh Rivera left corner. He'll dribble in. 4 seconds now. He'll rise with the right hand, and he'll get the floater to fall. Fordham back on top four. It's 12-8 Rams. 11:43 and ticking first half.
Man, aren't the Rams happy to have Josh Rivera back? They missed buckets like that that come seemingly out of nowhere.
Here's Jalen Quinn, the backup point guard. The knee-high dribble with the left hand. Fake the three at the top of the circle. Now caught with Antrell Charlton on him. Spins around and finds another teammate in Tom Welch. And man, a wide open cutter down low. Des Watson jams it home. And Loyola Chicago right back within two. It's 12-10 Rams, 11-10 and ticking first half.
Watson went with the polite two-hand slam. Wanted to make sure that ball went down. Knows Fordham can get up there vertically.
Here's Kyle Rose, left corner. Dribble drive the baseline, and it's swatted out of play by Jalen Dawson. It'll stay right here with the Fordham Rams, but with 11:02 to play in the first half, that will stop the clock. It's 12-10. Fordham Rams on top, and with that, we'll send it back to our Rose Hill studios for a scoreboard update with Andrew Canary.
the one-on-one scoreboard.
Looking across the rest of the A-10, the matchup between George Washington and the UMass Minutemen is heating up, with UMass taking the early lead. The score there is 44-36. Down in Ohio, Dayton is defending their number one conference ranking against Rhode Island. The game has 2 minutes left in the first half, with Dayton in the lead 44-23. For the rest of college hoops, number 9 ranked Baylor takes on the Longhorns in Texas. The score right now is 50-50, all tied up. And locally, St. John's is looking to bounce back from two consecutive losses in their game against Marquette at Madison Square Garden. The score right now is 48-45, with St. John's holding the lead. With the one-on-one scoreboard, I'm Andrew Crinieri.
And welcome back inside Rose Hill Gym. Your score, 12-10, Fordham Rams on top, 11:02 to play first half. We're going to take a quick break and turn to the third member of our crew, Dan Bartels.
Miles, thank you. From not getting more than 30 minutes per game in his first 10 appearances this year, Will Richardson has exceeded 30 minutes per game 4 out of his last 6 appearances. He has 0 points tonight, and on an errant shot on the side of the backboard, Kurt Jogo said, "Come on, get up, get your head back in the game." The absence of Jaffe Madore, it'll be interesting to see how Fordham's guard play shapes up moving forward down the stretch.
And that is a great point, Dan. Thank you very much for that. The absence of Jaffe Madore is major for the Fordham Rams. 16.6 points per contest over his last 5 games. And the Fordham Rams facing a really tough Loyola Chicago defense without their leading scorer. And Will Richardson, he's expected to step up today. I think heading into his sophomore campaign at the top of the year, he came with some lofty expectations. He hasn't lived up to them yet, but now with Jaffe Madore on the sidelines, today is an opportunity.
And Richardson has struggled over the course of his last couple of games, specifically over his last 2 contests, 5 of 20 from the field, 3 of 12 from distance. Those numbers are going to have to improve, especially for a point guard that plays more like a shooting guard at times. We talk about the scoring as it pertains to Jaffe Madore, but we forget he's second on the team in terms of assists. Fordham is going to miss that type of facilitator that he can become at times over the course of a game.
Absolutely. So back underway at Rose Hill Gym, here's Jameer Tripp, the 6'6" freshman, dribble drive at the top of the key. He'll draw the foul. This one's on the floor. It'll be on Jalen Quinn. And that'll stop the clock. 10:59 to play first half. It's 12-10, the Fordham Rams, narrowly on top in an awfully low-scoring affair here in the Bronx. The 5 out there for the Fordham Rams. Antrell Charlton, Jameer Tripp, Kyle Rose, Abdu Simbila, and Ramad Dean. And Jameer Tripp will step to the free throw line. The Fordham Rams have worked their way into the bonus with 11 minutes to play in the half. The rest of the way, it's a 1-1 situation. Here's Jameer Tripp. He's good on the front end. He'll earn another, and it's 13-10 Fordham Rams.
The Our Savior Lutheran product, Jameer Tripp, has began conference play very well. 10 of 16 from the field so far entering this one in conference play.
And Jameer Tripp, a 2 of 2 trip there. Only a 65%er, but he'll see that number tick up there. It's 14-10. The Fordham Rams on top, 10:58 and ticking first half. Here's the backup point guard, Jalen Quinn, to walk it up on the block F. Knee-high dribble with the right hand. He bounces it near side for Adelkhan. Adelkhan back to Quinn at the top of the circle. He'll attack from the left side, and he's got it swatted. Abdu Simbila with the block and ahead to Kyle Rose. Rose, top of the circle, takes the Abdu screen now. Looks to drive into the left elbow. Finds Jameer Tripp on the left perimeter. Down low. Back to Jameer Tripp. Now gets it back from Abdu Simbila. He'll look to drive in from the left side. Flip it up with the right hand. He's no good. Too strong. Off the back of the heel. And Jaden Dawson the other way for the Ramblers in red. Looking down low for Phillip Alston, and Phillip Alston draws some contact. He's been silent all day, but he gets an opportunity at the free throw line with 10:15 to play in the half. It's 14-10 Fordham Rams with 2 free throws coming for the senior forward, Phillip Alston.
Alston has a chance to get his first points of the day. He's not the kind of guy you're going to keep quiet for very long. 6'6", 235 pounds. He is a super talented senior that can score from anywhere on the court.
And Philip Alston rattles around and down on the first of two free throws. And he's a really interesting case. He's one of the better scorers on this team. In fact, statistically speaking, the best scorer at 14.6 points per game. 3 years of Division II called California University in Pennsylvania. Yes, I said that correctly. California University in Pennsylvania. But he's no good on the second free throw there. And Antrell Charlton will pick it up the other way. Find Kyle Rose left arc. He'll pop the three and rattle it home right there. And the Fordham Rams, a 17-11 advantage, 10 to play in the half.
That's a shot that Kyle Rose works on religiously. And when it's going down, the Fordham offense looks a whole lot different in terms of the options they have at their disposal.
Loyola Chicago, a burst of speed into the offensive half. Here's Des Watson, back his way down on Charlton. He'll fade from 10, and he'll rattle home the mid-range J. Right back with the answer there. It's 17-13, Fordham with the basketball. Antrell Charlton, top of the circle, angles right in on Dawson. Braden Norris, the point guard, switches on to him. Dribble drive right side, and Antrell Charlton loses his dribble. Ahead to Des Watson is Loyola Chicago. Watson, skip pass, two-hand, overhead pass, skips it through the hands of Jaden Dawson, and out of play right over the Fordham Ram bench. And Loyola Chicago turns it right back over to Fordham. 9:19 to play in the first half. It's 17-13 Fordham.
And if you ever wanted to know how competitive Des Watson is, just look at his reaction after he airmailed that pass. Was furious with himself. Just kind of screaming at himself, giving himself what to. Miles, that's what competitors do. They realize when they make a mistake in the game and then they work to correct it during that same contest.
So now Zach Riley to walk it up, who had some valuable minutes in their most recent game. Hands off for the curling. Will Richardson, top of the key, fakes the three, dribble drive right side. The scoop off the glass and down. 19-13, Fordham on top six. 9 minutes to play in the first half.
That's much more of Will Richardson's comfort zone in the mid-range. Just did a nice job cutting towards the cup.
And Braden Norris getting harassed by Kyle Rose. Gets loose, left side, flips up top. Here's Greg Dolan, dribble drive, dumps it down low, finds Welch, and he's got the shot swatted. Fordham going the other way. Here's Richardson, finds Zach Riley in transition. Top of the circle, flips it right back to Will Richardson, righty slot. Left-hand dribble, he'll penetrate a little bit, looking for the lob, and Abdu can't come down with it. Philip Alston does and immediately steps on the end line for Loyola Chicago. So the Fordham Rams will be gifted another possession, 8:34 to play first half. 19-13, Fordham Rams on top with the basketball. And Colin, this is a very impressive start amidst the injury of Jafe Madore.
And Fordham with an opportunity to create a little bit more separation. You can't squander opportunities like this when the Ramblers give you basically a free possession.
Here's Zach Riley, top of the key, tried to hand off for Richardson, but the pressure from Norris prevented it. They'll flip it high post for Will Richardson. 4 seconds on the shot clock now. Richardson, left side, he'll pull the triple. No good, short there. Off the left side of the iron, and Philip Alston corrals the loose ball. Flips it down low, Welch in transition, and another block, but they'll call the foul on Abdu. My goodness, Tom Welch got loose. Abdu recovered, slapped it out of his hands, but they'll call the body contact. So two free throws coming for the graduate forward, Tom Welch. It's 19-13, Fordham on top, 8:10 to play in the first half.
And that's a foul that you live with if you're Coach Keith Ergo. You don't obviously want Abdu Simbila to get into early foul trouble, as he's done multiple times this season, but you also don't want Welch to have an easy lane to the basket and change the momentum of this game with a big slam dunk.
So the high-arcing free throw falls out of the right hand of Tom Welch, and Welch was one of three Ramblers to appear in all 31 games last season, made 19 starts, in a little bit of a smaller role this year. I mean, that goes to show how talented Loyola Chicago is this year. I mean, last year, Tom Welch was an everyday starter. This year, he's been bumped to the second unit.
And Welch last season was really impressive. Was fifth in the country in terms of two-point field goal percentage, shot at a 73.3% clip.
So a 2-of-2 trip there out of the right hand of Tom Welch. It's 19-15, Fordham on top with the basketball. Here's Will Richardson, cuts in on Welch, flips it back right corner. Here's Elijah Gray, left-hand dribble, backing his way into the lane, flips high post for Ahmad Dean, fakes the three. Here's the second time. The high arcer is well short there, and nobody got a piece of it. And Keith Ergo is very angry with his Fordham Rams. An ugly offensive possession there as the ball dribbles out of play. That'll stop the clock with 7:46 to play in the first half. It is 19-15. Fordham Rams on top. This is Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hi, this is Mike Breen, WFUV class of 1983. WFUV is the flagship station of Fordham Athletics with live coverage of Fordham football, Fordham men's and women's basketball, in addition to Saturday one-on-one. Stay right here on 90.7 FM for all things WFUV sports.
To play in the first half. Your score 19-15. Fordham Rams on top. I'm Miles Grossman. He's Colin Loughran as we welcome you back inside the comforts of Rose Hill Gym. It's the Fordham Rams in Loyola, Chicago. And Colin, the Fordham Rams knew what kind of defensive challenge they were facing today. They've been held to just 19 points with 7:46 to play in the half, but they've held Loyola Chicago down as well, keeping up on the defensive end.
The Rams have done a nice job defensively. They haven't let Alston or Watson beat them to bits quite yet. I would be more concerned about the offensive side of the ball at this point in the game if I were Fordham, specifically because without Jafe Madur, you don't have anyone that can create off the dribble at will. Will Richardson still is not at that point in his collegiate career. You look at someone like Ramlad Dean, even on that last shot attempt, shot it off the dribble, didn't go down. They have a lot of guys that can hit threes on a spot-up type of situation, that sort of offensive level. They don't have someone that can initiate and really be productive at the point of attack. That's why, Miles, going forward, it's critical that they let Angelo Charlton general this offense and serve as that sort of point guard. He leads the team in terms of assists. He only took three shots from the field last time out against Davidson. You need him to either A, accept that he's going to be the main facilitator, or B, try to create something off of his own dribble in the mid-range, which is an aspect of his game that he excels at.
Absolutely. And you know what? Antro Charlton also led this team in assists last year. He's very comfortable in that role. He's known as the jack of all trades, the Swiss Army knife, are two names that get tossed around this program. It'll be interesting to see how he's used the rest of the way. But back underway here, Loyola Chicago to walk it up. Here's Braden Norris in on Kyle Rose, block F. He angles left side on the left perimeter now. Kyle Rose applies the pressure. Braden Norris skips right side. Here's Jaden Dawson looking down low. He finds his man in Adele Kuhn, and Adele Kuhn will rise through the contact. No finish, but Elijah Gray whistled for the foul, so it'll be two more free throws for Dame Adele Kuhn, the graduate forward, the Dortmund transfer. And that'll, excuse me, this time around, is Patrick Mwamba, the graduate forward, the Oral Roberts transfer. Pardon me there, but it'll be a clock stoppage at 7:26 to play in the first half. It's 19-15, Fordham Rams on top. Two shots for Loyola Chicago.
Mwamba, an underrated part of this Rambler team, played with Oral Roberts, as you mentioned, Miles, in an NCAA tournament, averaged 7.9 points and 5.9 rebounds with them this year. 10 steals and 5 blocks on the season. Just doesn't get enough time to really show who he is as a player. Mm-hmm. But with a 6'7", 210-pound frame, he's got a very high ceiling.
He's got some NCAA tournament experience, if you remember that Oral Roberts team that made it a few years back. He wraps up a productive trip there, 1 of 2, brings Loyola Chicago back within 3. It's 19-16. Fordham on top with the basketball, 7:15 and taking first half. Here's Richardson, crossover, pops the 3 and nails it. A beautiful release there for Richardson. It's 22-16 Fordham, 7 minutes to play in the first half. Here's Mwamba Top of the circle, drops it down low for Dame Adelkun. Adelkun back to him, Wanda, a little two-man game. Top of the key, he'll pop the three. No good off the left side of the iron. Riley comes down with the rebound. He gets slapped, and it'll be a 1-1 on the other side for Zach Riley here. 22-16, Fordham on top with 6:53 left in the first half. This is the start one could only dream of a few days ago, Colin.
And it's been a key sequence for Fordham the last two plays alone. You get a three-pointer off the dribble from Will Richardson. That's a shot he works on pregame with Henry Lowe before just about every game. Coach Henry Lowe, assistant on this Ergo staff. And then Riley with a big offensive board gets hacked, gets to the free throw line.
So Riley good on the first of two, earns the second free throw. He's only a 57%er on the campaign, but he's good right there to get into the box score. It's a 23-16 Fordham lead, 6:53 to play in the first half. Here's the second free throw out of the right hand of Zach Riley, and he rattles it home. 24-16, Fordham on top, 6:53 to play, first half.
And Richardson pressing up on Loyola Chicago. He's going to try and take on Greg Dolan way before the circle.
Here's Greg Dolan to walk it up, crosses over on Will Richardson on the block F. Crosses once again left to right, angles around to the right arc, back to the basket, fades away from 15 feet, no good. Right and short off the iron. Abdu clears the board and ahead to Will Richardson. 6.5 to play in the first half. Here's Kyle Rose in the offensive half, and he loses control. Some good defensive pressure out of Dez Watson. And Charlton just flips it out of play. Rose flips it out of play, far side, and that'll stop the clock with 6.5 to play in the first half. It's 24-16 Rams.
That was a solid poke by Watson, but more so Rose just didn't do a good job of keeping his dribble. Hard, tried to get a little bit too fancy.
So Greg Dolan once again this time walks it up on Zach Riley. A burst of speed into the left side mid post. Back to the basket once again. Flips it outside for Watson. Watson goes to work. Fades from 10 feet. No good. Short off the iron. Tom Welch going for the putback. That's short as well. And Ramad Dean clears the rebound for the Fordham Rams.
That was a wonderful contest from Riley on Dez Watson. Just got a hand in his grill right at the right time.
Richardson flips it low post for Abdu Simbila. Gets it back. Top of the key. He'll heave the three. No good. Off the left side of the iron, and Dawson rips free the Loyola Chicago rebound. 5:45 in ticket first half. Here's Dez Watson, top of the circle. Lobs it down low. Here's Phillip Alston. Phillip Alston going to work from the left block on Abdu, and he fades from five, and it's nothing but net. 24-18, Loyola Chicago back within six. 5.5 to play in the first half.
And that wasn't a bad defensive series from Simbila. Alston just did a nice job of finding space, found a little crevice to work with, and stuck the shot in Simbila's face.
Richardson bounces high post for Antrell Charlton. Got it on the left side perimeter, now getting harassed by Dez Watson once again. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Antrell Charlton dragged the pivot, doesn't get called for it. Finds Ramad Dean, left arc. Will Richardson now top of the key as the shot clock expires. No good off the back of the heel, and the foul on the floor. Zach Riley draws the foul, going for the loose ball, and it'll be another 1-1 for the Fordham Rams. And that'll stop the clock with 5:04 to play in the half. It's still 24-18 Fordham Rams, with Zach Riley a 1-1 opportunity.
And already Zach Riley has had an impact game. He's made a couple of nice contests, has 2 points with a chance to get some more points on the scoreboard. He's someone that has struggled this year, 6 of 23 from behind the three-point line this season. That was a number that Fordham was hoping was going to be a lot better for him. So for him to come out in this fashion today against a Loyola Chicago team that has a lot of guards that can go up against him, certainly impressive.
So a 2-of-2 trip once again for Zach Riley. And the Fordham Rams up 26-18 now. 5:04 to play in the first half. The veteran point guard Braden Norris checks back in and will hush it up on Will Richardson. Dribble with the right hand, crosses over top of the circle, angles his way to the left arc now. Will have his back to the basket, left side mid post. In on Will Richardson, drops it down low for Adelkun. Adelkun loses control, and the Fordham Rams force another steal. Here's Will Richardson loose in the front court, and the scoop lay off the window and down. 28-18, Fordham a double-digit lead. Here's Loyola Chicago quickly taken out of the basket. Phillip Alston, the scoop, no good on the reverse. He gets his own miss now, bodies his way in, and they'll call the offensive foul. Yole Akuovo got his feet set down low, and Phillip Alston is awfully frustrated. 28-18, Fordham Rams up 10 with the ball.
And that was an overly aggressive play from Alston. Alston undersized when he's in that position right under the hoop, so perhaps he felt the need to be more physical to create space, when in reality all he had to do was step back a bit and Yole Akuovo would have either fouled him and sent him to the line or not been able to contest.
Yole Akuovo getting some valuable minutes this afternoon. Hands off for Jameer Tripp. Top of the circle, down low now. Josh Rivera muscles his way in and the righty finish. Fordham on top, 12, 30-18. Des Watson in transition. He can't hit the righty lay and the Fordham Rams have numbers now. Here's Jameer Tripp the other way. Kicks out left corner. Josh Rivera now will slow things down, back to the basket, finds Antrell Charlton, top of the key. He'll pull up from 15, and he's no good. Rattles it in and out, just short there. And Greg Dolan the other way for Loyola in their maroons. Up top, Tom Welch now top of the circle. 3:39 to play in the first half. It's 30-18 Fordham Rams. Des Watson, right elbow jumper, and he rattles it home once again right there. Des Watson will silence the crowd a little bit. Stop the clock with 3:30 to play in the half. It's 30-20 Fordham Rams.
Welch with a textbook screen just allowed Watson to work right over him. Got an easy look from the mid-range. If Welch is able to do that going forward for this Rambler team, it changes what guys like Watson, Alston, even someone like Jaden Dawson are able to go. Those screens, those high screens specifically, can be deadly at this level of basketball.
So 3:30 to play in our first 20 minutes. It's 30-20, the Fordham Rams on top, and with that, we'll send it back to our Rose Hill studios for another scoreboard update with Andrew Canary.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
You said I wasn't doing.
Hi, this is Michael Kay, WFUV class of 1982. WFUV is your home for all things Fordham athletics, with live coverage of Fordham football, Fordham men's and women's basketball, in addition to our Saturday show, One-on-One. Stay right here on 90.7 FM for all things WFUV sports.
Welcome back inside the Rose Hill Gym. 3:30 to play in our first half. It's 30-20. The Fordham Rams on top. I'm Miles Grossman. We're now going to turn to the third member of our crew, our sideline reporter, Dan Bartels.
Miles, thank you. The big men will look to be a big point as this game progresses. As centers for both sides, Dame Adelican for Loyola has two fouls, and Elijah Gray has two for Fordham as well. Abdu Sambila, Fordham's starting center, only has one, but after Gray collected his second foul, Sambila was getting stretched out on the sideline, and a big theme seems to be his ability to get up and down the court as this game progresses. So something to watch out for, Miles, as this game goes on.
Absolutely, and the bigs have been known to be a deep position for the Fordham Rams, at least the four spot, not necessarily the five, but certainly being tested today against one of the deepest front courts in the A-10 out of Loyola.
And Fordham has done a nice job of testing the Ramblers' big men. So far, Loyola Chicago has turned the ball over seven times as opposed to Fordham's five turnovers. Fordham 0-5 when they commit more turnovers than their opponent. They have a chance to flip the script this afternoon.
Here's Will Richardson. He bounces left corner for Antrell Charlton. He looks to pass, and Phillip Alston got the left leg in the way. It'll be the kick ball. That'll reset the shot clock at 20. 3 minutes and 10 seconds to play in the first half. It's 30-20. The Fordham Rams on top with the basketball. Here's Will Richardson, the waist-high dribble with the right hand on the Fordham Ram logo. Eagles to the right side. Dribble drive the right side. He attacks. The scoop is no good. Short there, and Tom Welch rips free the Loyola rebound. Ahead to Jalen Dawson on the right side, looking down low for Alston, and Alston draws contact, from Jameer Tripp. This will be on the floor. Once again, a clock stoppage, 2:53 to play in the half. It's 30-20 Fordham Rams. Loyola Chicago basketball, baseline inbound in the offensive half.
This might be an unpopular opinion. I would have liked to have seen Dawson pull up from three there. He's 44% from downtown this season. And when you got it cooking like that, let it fly, especially with a smaller defender in your face.
Absolutely right, Colin. So here's Brayden Norris to start the possession. Finds Dawson, top of the key. He'll drive. He'll scoop home the floater there off the right side of the iron and down. It's a 30-22 lead for Fordham. 2:40 and ticking. First half. Will Richardson slowly trots up now. Flips it high post. Here's Josh Rivera. Takes the Abdu Simbila screen. Josh Rivera now spins around. Right side short corner up top for Jameer Tripp. Thought about the three. He'll look to go to work on Alston. And he'll scoop home the right side lay. Off the window once again. And a 32-22 lead now for the Fordham Rams. Alston down low the other way. Rises and through the contact of Josh Rivera. This will be the first of the day on Josh Rivera. 32-22 is the Fordham Rams lead. But here's two free throws coming out of the right hand of Philip Alston, the senior forward.
That's been Loyola Chicago's MO so far on the offensive side of things, peppering the inside part of the painted area, trying to get as close to the basket as possible. They've done a decent job of drawing contact, but it's also come with a number of offensive fouls on their part.
So Alston, a deep bend of the knees, but he's well short on the first of two free throws, and I gotta appreciate the shoe game of Philip Alston. He's got the mismatched colorways of the Sabrina ones. Oof. A very popular shoe on this Loyola Chicago team.
Very astute observation. We always love a shoe check on the broadcast.
So one of two trip there for Alston, salvages something from the trip, makes it a 32-23 lead for the Fordham Rams. 2:10 and ticking first half as Will Richardson trots up and calls out the play. He'll bounce it for Josh Rivera on the left elbow. Finds Jameer Tripp, left block, spins around, rises, and he gets fouled. Some serious contact there. And now it'll be two free throws coming for Jameer Tripp. 2:01 to play in the half. It's 32-23 as it stands. And the Fordham Rams, a large part of that has been Jameer Tripp, but the Fordham Rams have done a spectacular job of getting to the free throw line. Colin, they were in the bonus with 11 minutes to play in the half. That's not their MO.
And I think it's the kind of game Fordham has played offensively. They've been moving very well. There's been times this year where the offense looks stagnant, where Jaffe Madur or a Kyle Rose or an Antrel Charlton will stand towards the top of the key and nobody is moving. That has not been the case this afternoon. Jameer Tripp, with his frame, 6'6", 230 pounds, the sort of player that will benefit from that movement, because when you're that big, Miles, someone's going to run into you. You're going to draw some contact.
So Jameer Tripp, free throw, no good on the second. He was good on the first. It's a 33-23 lead for Fordham. 1:58 in ticking in the first half. Here's the six-foot point guard, Brayden Norris, to walk it up. Hands off for the curling. Tom Welch at the top of the circle. One-on-one, hard of the paint, in on Abdu Simbila. Back to the basket, the extra move, and the pretty spin. In off the glass, and a 33-25 lead for Fordham. A minute 40 to play in the half.
Welch putting together a productive game. 4 points, 4 boards, 2 assists. Keep your eyes locked on him.
Richardson, top of the key, dishes down low for Josh Rivera, stuck in the left-hand corner. Backing his way down on the other side is Norris. And they'll call the foul on the floor. Josh Rivera will be headed to the free throw line, and the Fordham Rams in the double bonus here with 1:24 to play in the half. It's 33-25. And Josh Rivera, two more chances at the charity stripe. And Josh Rivera missed three games in A-10 play with quad tendonitis. But he returned on a minutes restriction 2 games ago. Limited time last time as well. And now here he is, well short on the first of two free throws. Or pardon me, one of the games he missed was in non-con play. But he did miss 3 games due to right quad tendonitis. And now he returns. He's a big part of the Fordham offense his first year as a Ram. He transferred over from Lafayette in the offseason.
And Rivera misses his first free throw, 50% from the charity stripe this season. That is a number that has to be better for a player with his skill set at his height. You'd expect him to be drawing contact left and right. When he does so, he needs to knock down those freebies.
So a 50%er hits at 50%. It's 34-25. Fordham on top. Here's the left arc three. Jaden Dawson will rattle it home there. His first of the day. And Loyola Chicago right back within six. It's 34-28, a minute left, first half.
An aggressive take from Jaden Dawson. Only a sophomore, a very confident take considering he's a sophomore.
Charlton, top of the key, crosses over on Edwards Jr., kicks right side. Here's Will Richardson. He'll find Josh Rivera at the top of the key, spins around on Norris, works his way into the paint, rises through Welch. He loses control of the basketball. Fordham Rams regain. Here's Jameer Tripp, left corner triple, no good, airballs it there, and that'll be a shot clock violation. Didn't even realize it was expiring, and that'll stop the clock with 37.6 to play in the half. It's 34-28, Fordham. I don't look now, Colin, but it does seem that Loyola Chicago a little bit of momentum to wrap up the half.
Fordham showing its age a little bit. They did so against Davidson late. They had a lead towards the latter part of that game, late at halftime. When you're a younger team, it's often hard to close out games, to close out halves. It's something that comes with age and experience.
So here's Dez Watson, the two guard, to walk it up now. 30 seconds left in the first half. About a 7 second differential. Shot clock and game clock in the half one. Dez Watson pushes off, pulls up from 16, and rattles home the jumper. And Kyle Rose is grabbing at his left hamstring. Will Richardson will rush it up and call for the timeout with 15.7 remaining. And it's a 34-30 Fordham lead. Once again, Keith Thurgill has his signature first half move of drawing up a play for the final offensive possession. But Loyola Chicago, a 5-1 run in the last minute 26, and they have clawed their way all the way back in this thing.
And this is something that Coach Ergo has done throughout the season. As you said, Miles, this may be the rare time where I don't agree with the choice for him to call that timeout towards the end of the first half. You have a team who's clearly getting a little bit tired, the wear and tear catching up to them. They played an excellent first half for the most part. Let the clock run down. Don't let your guys overthink the fact that they're ahead of a team that has as much talent as Loyola Chicago does have.
It's a good point, Colin. I mean, the Fordham Rams have done this every first half they've had the opportunity to. But it's interesting. It does create a bit of a stagnant coming out of a timeout. You arguably don't provide yourself any flow. And that's something that you see throughout basketball coaches' decisions is, well, we're going to go with what creates the best flow. And this timeout situation never really does. But the Fordham Rams, a 34-30 lead. 10 seconds on the game clock here in the first half. Will Richardson dribbles between the legs at the top of the circle. Spins around on Dawson, pulls up from 15, and he airballs it well short there. Out of bounds on the baseline. And that'll be a 1.9 second clock here in the first half. And the Fordham Rams once again come up empty coming out of the timeout.
And that's precisely why you have to question the choice to call the timeout. Will Richardson with a half-baked shot. He's had a mixed bag sort of game. You don't want him going into the break feeling defeated.
Welch heaves up top to Morris. Morris the pop, and he's well short there on the air ball. And that's how the first 20 minutes come to a close here in the Bronx. It's a 34-30 lead for your Fordham Rams over the Loyola Chicago Ramblers at 12-6. And Colin, that first half was awfully impressive, particularly early on. This is a top 60 defense in the nation per their KenPom numbers, and the Fordham Rams out-defense them.
The Rams did not close the half well, but they did begin this game strongly. They have a lead at halftime. That's what matters. Key that they'll have to reset at this half. Don't overthink the fact that they didn't close efficiently. Make sure you come out strong in the second act.
So 34-30 is the Fordham Rams lead at the break. And with that, we'll now send it back across the street to our Rose Hill studios for the halftime show with Chris Carrino and Andrew Canary.
The one-on-one halftime report.
Welcome into the Rose Hill Studios back here in the Bronx. I'm Chris Carrino, joined by the one and only Andrew Crinieri. Fordham leading the Loyola Chicago Ramblers 34-30 at the half. Andrew, how you doing?
Oh, I'm doing great. It's always fun watching some Fordham men's basketball, and it's been an impressive performance so far for this Fordham men's team.
Yeah, the start to this game, they said it on the air, on the call. Shout out to Colin and Miles doing a fantastic job in that first half. They said it's really been a pleasant surprise this game so far. I don't think a lot of Fordham fans saw this game on the calendar with how this team's been playing at home and how this team's been playing against upper caliber A-10 competition. Really, they've been kind of dominating the whole game so far.
Yeah, no, I mean, especially considering that Fordham is playing at home and they haven't had the best record as of late at home, and Loyola Chicago 4-1 in conference play, so they're an incredibly strong team.
Yeah, 2-2 in the conference, in the A-10, kind of mixed success. They've kept it close in those two losses as well. A lot of competitive games, but you kind of hinted at it there. This team's 4-6 at home this season. Definitely not what you would want to see from a Fordham team. I believe last year our producer, Julia Moss, or one of our producers along with Owen Kelty, said, I think we only lost one or two games at home last year. So this is definitely a change and something they're going to have to adjust to, but a win like this, so important for the rest of their schedule.
Oh, yeah, very much so. Very, very important. And we were talking about this a bit before the halftime and how it seems like this Fordham men's team kind of flip-flops between wins and losses, and it really seems like they can't build momentum and really, you know, make a stance in this A-10 conference.
Yeah, the A-10 conference in general has been kind of a smorgasbord. Not a ton of clear dominance yet so far. We obviously know Dayton is the team to beat, as they are a top 25 team in the country. But you look at around the middle of the pack, I think Loyola Chicago is on the upper echelon of that middle of the pack. Fordham kind of in the lower echelon of that. But Fordham kind of looking up at Loyola Chicago right now. Loyola Chicago definitely having a better conference season so far. What does it say about this Fordham team, Andrew, that they're not only keeping up with this Loyola Chicago team, but they kind of look like the better team so far?
I mean, it's incredibly impressive, and I think that it kind of speaks to what this Fordham men's team has been going through this entire season. They have capability for great things, and that it seems like for one reason or another, they haven't been able to put it together as of yet, but it seems like in this Loyola Chicago game, they're finally putting it together, and I think partly that is what kind of Coach Keith Urgo said before the game, which was the defense. Fordham's defense was, you know, something that has been really lacking in the past couple of games, especially their losses to Davidson most recently. And right now it seems like they're out defensing Loyola Chicago, which is ranked top 60, as our play-by-play Miles Grossman said.
Yeah, and also another aspect of this game we haven't touched on yet, Jafe Madore, someone who has probably been the most dominant figure in this Fordham offense all season long. He's out with an ankle injury after hurting himself against Davidson earlier in the week on Wednesday. They're playing well without him. Guys are really stepping up. Guys like Will Richardson are really stepping up. He's been efficient, 3-for-9 from the field. Kyle Rose, we saw it on Wednesday with the leadership and defense he was showing. He's translating that here tonight. Anybody on this Fordham roster, Andrew, that maybe you'd want a little bit more from, really just to kind of put this one out of reach for Loyola?
I mean, honestly, I would love to see Elijah Gray do a bit more. I mean, he's been amazing the past couple games, like really came into his own. I believe, yeah, over the past four games, he's averaging 15.5 points per game, 8.5 rebounds per game. He's looked amazing. So I could see him definitely, you know, making a bit more of a bit more noise in the second half to really close it out.
Yeah, Gray, a sophomore on this team, he played last year as a freshman, one of the only freshmen to get a ton of minutes last year. But he's definitely been an impact player for this team. Another guy I would love to talk about, Abdu Simbila, a guy that I think this offense should be ran through. He's just so dominant and so big, and he creates so many other chances for the players around him, and he is just so vital for this team. But looking at the final score of that first half, not a high score, Andrew, at all. Is that due to maybe good defense or inefficiency on the offensive end? Why is the score that low?
I think it's a really defensively sound game. If we look on both sides of the court, it seems like both teams are, you know, really, really strong in terms of, you know, not really creating that many opportunities for the opposing team and causing turnovers. One thing I do actually want to highlight, though, that I think could be something that the Rams team could work on in the second half is free throw percentage, specifically Joshua Rivera. I know Colin Loughran, our color analyst, talked about it during the game, but Joshua Rivera, for as good of a player as he is, I know he's, you know, still coming off of injury, had, I believe, some ankle trouble, something like that. But still, though, free throw percentages, I mean, those are free points. You can't be giving those up.
Yeah, and you felt the difference in how
I don't know what the word would be, but the discrepancy between Davidson's free throw percentage and Fordham's free throw percentage was felt immensely down the stretch of that game earlier this week. Davidson was just making every free throw every time they got fouled and went to the line, and it was really maybe the defining factor in why Fordham lost earlier in the week. So kind of seeing them translate that here tonight, seeing Zach Riley going 4-for-4, seeing Jameer Tripp going 3-for-4, these guys are shooting well now from the free throw line. If they can continue that, that is an aspect of their game that will keep them close in a lot of these games.
Oh, 100%. And I think that kind of speaks to consistency that this Fordham men's team is really trying to find. If they can work out the free throws, figure out the defense, which it seems like they are in this game at the very least, I think that we can see a lot more consistent of a Rams team heading out of this, hopefully after a win.
Yeah, consistency is the word you brought up there. You mentioned earlier how it does look very random when we look at the schedule and the final scores of a lot of these games. What is something, not necessarily even winning, just what is something they could bring to their game similar to the free throws where it would kind of just bring a level of consistency to themselves?
I'm trying to think. Honestly, I mean,
can I give you one?
Yeah, 100%.
I think shooting in general is a problem. You can't really affect it, so it's, I wouldn't give that answer, but if I was to give one, it would be shooting. But I think, honestly, on the defensive end, perimeter defense has been super important for them because I feel like once teams pack it inside, Simbilo's a great player inside, but he can't do everything. And I've seen this team too many times get beat by guys on the baseline, just guys in general driving to the rim. They need to protect that inside. They really need to take pride in perimeter defense, and I think maybe just a little more hard work, maybe a little more dirty work. You know, we see guys like Kyle Rose, guys of that nature diving for balls, maybe a few other guys. I wouldn't mind to see Will Rich dive for a loose ball. I mean, you know, the Reaper doesn't always do the dirty work, but he can if he has to. But just looking at this schedule before and going forward, this Fordham team, not in the best spot, but they look good right now, and honestly, personally, I'm feeling optimistic.
Yeah, no, definitely. I mean, I think we definitely have a second half to watch and see how it kind of turns out, and see if they continue, you know, the good play that they have in the first half. But looking at the schedule, yeah, I mean, after this game, they're heading into a game against Rhode Island, and then after that, Duquesne. I can definitely see this team being a lot more consistent, starting to stack up some wins in this A-10 conference. Yeah. And actually, you know, kind of make a push.
Yeah, I mean, three of the next four games on the road for this Fordham team, so definitely a bit of a gauntlet for the next couple weeks for Fordham. Kind of looking toward the second half, not getting too ahead of ourselves with the rest of the schedule, do you think that Fordham would be able to keep this pace, or do you expect Loyola to maybe have some sort of second half resurgence?
I can definitely see a bit of a resurgence from Loyola, honestly, more so than anything. I could see Fordham's defense, or not defense, offense faltering a little bit. If Will Richardson starts missing a couple shots, he's not as effective at the three-point, or maybe falls in love with the three-point a little bit too much, I can definitely see how that could be a problem. But yeah, we'll just have to wait and see. But I think Loyola Chicago, I mean, they're definitely a team that's not out of this game by any means.
Yeah, and one interesting stat I see on here when looking at the team stats, only three threes taken from Loyola Chicago in that first half. They made one of them, 1-for-3 from the three-point line. Fordham, 2-for-8. Maybe Loyola Chicago taking more threes could be the answer, but I'm not totally sure. It does feel even. It does, that the three-point percentage really feels like the only place where there's a massive discrepancy. Mm-hmm. It does feel like, for the most part, free throw percentage, field goal percentage, everything, offensive rebounds, defensive rebounds, seems very close-knit. I think the three-point percentage could be where that difference is made.
Oh, 100%. And we'll just have to wait and see while opportunities, you know, kind of arise. But off the back of that, I mean, I think that this has been an incredibly impressive first half for this Fordham men's team, and all I have to do is really just close it out and show that, you know, they can be a consistent team at home.
Yeah, absolutely. Fordham fans have a lot to be excited about, Andrew. Just final predictions from us before we hand it back to them for the second half. Looking at how that first half went, I think Fordham can continue this good play they've played today. I mean, obviously, they're not up a ton of points. They're only up 4. They really should be up more. I think that says something about maybe how they played toward the end of the first half. But if they can continue with the strong defensive play, transitioning into great offense that they had in that kind of beginning part of the first half, I think they're probably be in good shape.
Yeah, 100%. I think we definitely saw near the end of that first half them falter a little bit, fall behind, maybe get a little bit sluggish. Mm-hmm. But we saw at the beginning of that first half, they started off incredibly strong and had a fast start. So I think if they start the second half the same way, get off to a fast start, I think it's definitely going to be a win for the Fordham team.
That's it for us here in the Rose Hill Studios. I'm Chris Carrino, joined obviously by Andrew Crinieri. We're going to send it back to Colin and Miles in the Rose Hill Gym. We'll be back post-game. And yeah, everybody enjoy the second half.
Welcome back inside the conference of Rose Hill Gym. It's halftime between the Loyola Chicago Ramblers and your Fordham Rams. I'm Miles Grossman alongside Colin Loughran. And Colin, that was a weird first half. Jafe Medor has been absent, of course, due to the ankle injury. Abdu Simbila held scoreless down low, yet the Fordham Rams had a 10-point lead at moments throughout that first half. Of course, Loyola able to finish the half on a 5-0 run, claw right back within four. And now we got a tight one. The Fordham Rams, awfully impressive without two star players making a difference.
Right now, Loyola Chicago is struggling to figure out just how they're going to beat Fordham, because their typical strategy of pepper the paint, draw contact, and see what happens has not been working. When they get that pass towards the block, towards the painted area, Fordham has done a nice job of turning them over. This season, the Ramblers are 9-3 when they score more paint points than their opponent. Right now, Fordham has more paint points. They lead that margin 20-18. If that trajectory stays up, you can expect Fordham to win the day. Also critically, the Rams have done a nice job of keeping Philip Austin at bay. 1 of 3 from the field, only 4 points. Des Watson has had a better day by contrast. 4 of 7 from the field with 10 points. Right now, it's pick your poison, and Fordham has selected to slow down Alston at the expense of letting Watson do what he does. On the Rams side of things, offensively, who's going to step up? Who is it going to be in the second half here? Without Jafe Medor, a key man that I would look to is Jameer Tripp. You knew the freshman was going to have a coming out party of sorts at some point. So far today, he's played just over 10 minutes of the game, has 7 points, and is 2 of 5 from the field. Could they get that from him in this second half? That's going to be a major question.
And Jameer Tripp was pretty spectacular in those first 20 minutes. The Fordham Rams lead Loyola Chicago 18-9 when it comes to bench points. And of course, Jameer Tripp, 7 off the pine, are a lot to do with that. Josh Rivera, 5 off the bench. Zach Riley, 4 off the bench. They lead 18-9. That's a category I'm looking to see keep up in the final 20 minutes. Loyola Chicago, a very talented starting five, but they've held the bench silent, an absolute key. And Colin, you touched on it already, but Philip Alston's the offensive star of this team, 14.6 points per game. He leads Loyola Chicago in scoring. So you know when they turn to the scouting report, he was the first name they saw, and they've done a very solid job of limiting the primary option. What worries me a tad is, like you said, Des Watson getting hot, and also Loyola Chicago has not attempted many threes, but when they have, they've been open. I'm a little worried that Loyola Chicago is the type of squad that can get hot from range. Fordham gotta be solid when it comes to perimeter D.
And that's a question in terms of strategy, Miles. Loyola Chicago's first inclination is not to shoot the three ball. They'd much rather live around that painted area. If they make an adjustment and decide, you know what, today's gonna be the day where we decide to let loose from behind the arc, this game could look completely different because they have guys that can knock them down. You look at someone like Jaden Dawson. So far, he's been very good. He's made a three already in this game, has 7 points. If he gets a bigger role in this second half, then the onus is on Fordham to adjust to that adjustment. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely right, Colin. So just about 30 seconds from getting underway between the Loyola Chicago Ramblers and the Fordham Rams in half number two. And these two squads, really a different story when it comes to the beginning of Atlantic 10 play. Loyola Chicago is a dominant 4-1 start to conference play on the other side. The Fordham Rams hanging around 500, 2 wins on the road, 2 losses in this building. And they're looking for that gritty second half performance that we've seen on the road. They're going to need to channel that same energy in the final 20 minutes here in the Bronx.
There's no question that Loyola Chicago feels they were undervalued at the start of this season amongst other A-10 coaches, amongst the media. They feel like they're a program that has some pedigree and has a real chance to make some noise in the conference.
So an identical starting five out there for each of the two squads. The backcourt for the Fordham Rams, Will Richardson, Antrell Charlton, and Kyle Rose. Up front, it's Ramad Dean in his first start of his Fordham career, and Abdu Sabila, the big man down low, who is held scoreless through 20 minutes. On the other side for Loyola Chicago, Braden Norris, Jaden Dawson, Dez Watts in the backcourt, Philip Alston, as we said, the senior forward, and down low, Miles Rubin, the 6'10" freshman. So back underway from Rose Hill. Loyola Chicago in there. Road Maroons moving right to left on the Fordham Rams. They trail by four. Here's Miles Rubin on the left side. Hands off for Jaden Dawson. He takes it and hits the floater immediately. Dawson has Loyola right back within two. 34-32 Fordham Rams.
Dawson with that lanky build. A Brandon Ingram-esque shot that time.
Top of the key. Ramad Dean fakes the handoff. Flips it high post. Looking down low for Abdu Sembila. But Miles Rubin the steal and the other way for Loyola Chicago. A bucket and a steal out of the gate for Loyola Chicago in the second half. Dribble drive, center of the paint, and Dez Watson will draw some contact. This one's going to be on Kyle Rose. That'll stop the clock. 19-17 to play in regulation. It's 34-32. Fordham on top, but two free throws coming for the sophomore guard. Excuse me, the junior guard, Dez Watson.
Rose got a little bit too handsy there. When you lead your team in steals, your natural thought process goes towards trying to pick someone's pocket. But when you have an offensive player charging at you, you have to be careful not to get too cute with anything.
So Dez Watson, the sole double-figure scorer in the first half, 10 to be exact, is good on the first of two free throws, has him up to 11, no good off the right iron on the second. And a 1-of-2 trip has Fordham up just a sole point, 34-33. Will Richardson on the block F. He'll bounce it left elbow for Ramad Dean. Back to the basket, curling around. He'll hand off for Antrell Charlton. He'll dump it down low for Abdu and kisses it off the glass and down. Abdu Sembila, the deuce, and has Fordham up three. But Kyle Rose immediately commits the reach-in foul as he will head to the bench. Jameer Tripp is called on. Just a minute into the second half, Kyle Rose, two back-to-back fouls to start the second half, and he will head to the pine there. Up to three, I believe, Colin. Or pardon me, that's just going to be his second. So Loyola Chicago the other way. Here's up top, top of the circle, Braden Norris. Bounces for the center, Miles Rubin right side. Hands off for the curling Norris, looks for the oop down low, and the lefty finish for Miles Rubin. A little two-man game for Norris and Rubin, and Loyola Chicago right back within one.
I was waiting for Miles Rubin to do something. Does something there in a big way, a nice little finish. 6'10", 205 pounds. This guy was a three-star high school recruit. He can change the game in an instant, even as a freshman.
36-35, the Fordham Rams the lead in the basketball. Antrell Charlton top of the circle. Braden Norris spins onto him. He'll pull up from 15 and he'll can the fadeaway. Fordham back on top three, 38-35, 2 minutes into the second half.
Charlton now has 4 points on the contest. He would love a few more looks like that.
And Rubin looks to flip it down low, but Abdu Sembila picks off the pass, gets hacked from behind by Philip Alston, and the Fordham Rams force a turnover with 18:02 to play in regulation and a 3-point lead, 38-35. Will Richardson now awfully slow to walk it up with a right-hand dribble on the block F. Angles his way to the right side perimeter. Takes the Abdu Sembila screen and bounces it high post for Ramad Dean. Dean kicks left arc. Antrell Charlton bounces left block. Abdu Sembila. Sembila spins around, rises with the left hand. He can hit. And Jameer Tripp can't pull down the rebound ahead in transition. Dawson high off the left glass and in. Loyola Chicago right back within one on the transition deuce. Jameer Tripp, once again in transition, flips high post for Ramad Dean. 17 and a half to play in regulation. It's 38-37. Fordham Rams on top. Richardson on the block F, dribbles behind the back, angles left side. He'll pull up left side, triple, no good. Airballs it 2 feet right as it bounces out of play on the baseline. An ugly shot there. Man, oh man, 17-12 to play in the half. Fordham turns it right back over to Loyola.
Miles, that shot runs so hot and cold for Will Richardson off the dribble from behind the arc. You never know exactly what you're going to get. It's a skill that he is still working on. Don't know if I would have pulled the trigger there at this time in the ballgame.
So So the air ball there out of bounds for Will Richardson, and Des Watson to walk it up the other way for Loyola, trailing by one. Just checked in the second half is Adele Kuhn. Adele Kuhn drops it down low for the cutting Dawson, and the reverse lay for Jaden Dawson off the window and down in Loyola Chicago, their first lead in quite a while, 39-38 over the Fordham Rams, 16-45 second half.
Who says big man can't pass? A dime there from Adele Kuhn, a rare dime from a center in a 10 play.
And in the effort play, Jaden Dawson will force the jump ball, snatch it out of the hands of Charlton at the top of the key, but the possession arrow will keep it right here with the Fordham Rams. It'll be the left side sideline inbound with 16:41 to play. And we got some substitutions for Fordham. Will Richardson off, Zach Riley on. To Jameer Tripp, the far sideline inbound, chest pass into Josh Rivera, top of the circle, attacks in, dumps it down low, and Elijah Gray, the scoop finish under the basket. Fordham regains the lead, 40-39.
Nice offensive possession for Fordham, nothing too crazy, just a slow and steady progression towards the basket.
And Adele Kuhn muscling his way past Elijah Gray, but he can't hit with the left hand. Gray the rebound, and Fordham the other direction. They lead 40-39, 16-16 left in regulation. Josh Rivera top of the key, fake the three, and we'll pull back and dish up top for Antrell Charlton on the block F. He's getting harassed by Jaden Dawson at the top of the circle. Swings it right side for Zach Riley. Riley cuts in and gets fouled from behind. This one's going to be on Braden Norris. That'll stop the clock with 16 minutes even. One of those good old-fashioned 16-minute flat media timeouts. It's a 40-39 lead for the Fordham Rams. You're listening to Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hi, my name is Ryan Rucco, WFUV class of 2008. WFUV is your home for all things Fordham athletics, with live coverage of Fordham football, Fordham men's and women's basketball, in addition to our Saturday show, One-on-One. Stay right here on 90.7 FM for all things WFUV sports.
The Fordham Rams narrowly hanging on with Loyola. Nine of their last 10 shots have fallen from the field. Welcome back inside Rose Hill Gym. 16 minutes to play. It's 40-39. Fordham on top. But we're going to turn now to Dan Bartels, our sideline reporter.
Miles, thank you. Miles Rubin for Loyola has only played 3 minutes and 10 seconds in the first half and played the opening 2 minutes and 30 seconds of the second half, and he's responsible for that 9-6 run that we just saw. But the highly touted 6'10 freshman tallied 3 blocks last game versus the UMass Minutemen, bringing his season total to 42. Rubin needs just 2 more blocks to tie for 10th place on the program's single season list, set by Ben Aberkamp in the 2009-2010 season. He currently ranks 12th in the country in total blocks. Fordham will look to contain Rubin down the stretch, as his presence could be the difference in this one, Miles.
Absolutely, Dan. Miles Rubin, a force to be reckoned with down low at 6'10". He's awfully lanky at just 205 pounds. And Colin, you noted this a couple minutes ago. He just made a pretty play, but he's been silent early going. And, you know, Miles Rubin's is a funny situation. He gets the start regularly, but he often gets pulled just maybe 2-3 minutes into the game. Adele Kuhn alongside Tom Welch. It's an awfully deep front court. So Miles Rubin, while he is talented as a freshman, they pull him awfully quickly.
And you mentioned the funky starts. I think that shows the kind of support that young players can get at a program like Loyola Chicago. If you play as a freshman, you start as a freshman, there's a certain amount of pressure that comes with that that you have to produce. Pulling a guy early gives them that confidence that we're going to start you, but we want you to earn your minutes down the stretch.
So Elijah Gray in on the inbound Loughran's pass, no good, but an offensive rebound. Jameer Tripp will keep it right here. Spins around from the right elbow. Off the glass, no good, but Elijah Gray, another offensive rebound, no good with the left hand, and Zach Riley pokes it out of play on the near sideline. Last touch, Fordham Rams. That'll stop the clock. 15:41 to play in the second half. 40-39, Fordham, Loyola Chicago basketball.
Elijah Gray did a nice job crashing the offensive glass. He only played just under 4 minutes in the first half of the ballgame. He's someone Fordham would like to get some scoring from off the bench here in the second.
So here's Greg Dolan now to walk it up. He bounces high post for Des Watson. Watson attacks from the right side, drills behind the back, loses control. Adele Kuhn keeps it right here, comes up with a loose ball. Backs his way down in on Elijah Gray, spins around, gets loose, and the scoop under the basket is down. Loyola Chicago regains the lead, 41-40. Mantrell Charlton to walk it up now, flips it high post for Elijah Gray. Thought about the three, now the lob pass down low, looking for Rivera. Loyola Chicago and Greg Dolan tapping out a play on the offensive baseline of Fordham. It'll stay here. 15:01 to play in the half. It's 41-40. Loyola Chicago on top. Fordham basketball. Charlton bounces near side, short corner in for Rivera. Rivera rises and gets fouled there. So two free throws coming for Josh Rivera. It's a 41-40 lead for Loyola Chicago, but an opportunity to regain the lead with 14:58 for the Fordham Rams.
A skillful take from Josh Rivera. Kept the ball towards his head, didn't lower the ball towards his abdomen. What that does is it allows you to keep it in your hand, doesn't let the defender poke it away, gets rewarded with a trip to the line after the shot attempt.
So Rivera, the 50%er on the campaign, no good off the right side of the iron. And Colin, he was 1-for-2 on his previous trip. He's seen this number rise throughout the campaign. He started off as about a 35%er on the year. Went on about a 9-of-10 trip at Madison Square Garden, believe it or not. Saw that number rise, and now he's good on the second. Evens us up at 41 apiece, and he stays at that 50% clip on the day and on the campaign, believe it or not. So here's Greg Dolan, angles to the left side, flips high post for Adele Kuhn. One-on-one in on Elijah Gray. Here's the spin and the kiss off the glass with the left hand. A pretty finish there for the bench big. It's a 43-41 Loyola lead.
Adele Kuhn with a spin move that time. 8 points now, a rebound and an assist, putting together a nifty stat line.
And Josh Rivera looking for the lob down low for Jameer Tripp, but he misses it. The errant pass dribbles out of play on the offensive baseline of Fordham, turning it right back over to Loyola. 14:27 to play in the game. It's a 43-41 Loyola lead with the basketball. And Colin, now we're going to see some of that signature 1-3-1 press out of the Fordham Rams.
Yeah, Miles, there are possessions over the course of the game when you can say that a team needs either a bucket or a stop. This is one of those possessions. Fordham really needs a stop, needs to keep within striking distance.
And just as you say that, Colin, they forced the stop. The big was caught up. Dame Adele Kuhn at the top of the circle, near side forecourt to be exact. He got caught in the trap and just traveled. Tried to dribble through Antrell Charlton, but picked it up. And now the Fordham Rams will have the possession, trailing by two, 14:21 to play in the second half. 43-41 Loyola. Here's Antrell Charlton, knee-high dribble with the right hand on Des Watson. Block F. He'll find Elijah Gray, top of the circle. Hesitation dribble, angles his way to the right side, short corner. Elijah Gray back to the basket, fades from 10. The high arcer, no good, off the left side of the iron. Out of bounds is Greg Dolan going for the rebound. He did not make contact with it, so Elijah Gray the last touch. 14:03 to play, 43-41 Loyola with the ball.
Coach Ergo letting Elijah Gray hear it from the sideline. He didn't like that shot attempt. A little bit of a fadeaway look from Elijah Gray. That's not his game necessarily.
There's Dolan, top of the key. He finds Des Watson. Des Watson, two-hand skip pass left corner. Edwards Jr., left corner three. He'll pop. No good off the back of the heel there. A loose rebound all the way to the right side. Antrell Charlton comes down with it. Chest pass ahead to Jameer Tripp on the outlet pass. Tripp crosses over, pulls it back once again. Right side, short corner, finds Gray, top of the key. He'll pop the three, and nothing but net there for Elijah Gray. Fordham back on top, 44-43.
Now that is much more in Gray's wheelhouse. He's become a very skillful spot-up shooter over the course of this season. He's now got 7 points, Miles.
So Fordham commits the foul on the floor. And that'll stop the clock with 13:24 to play. But Fordham, a momentous three-point shot out of the right hand of Elijah Gray. And they are back on top, 44-43, 13:21 to play in the second half. Here's Braden Norris, the starting point guard. Chest pass up top for Dolan. Finds Des Watson on the lefty slot. Now lobs it down low for Alston. Back up top now for Norris. Norris, the extra pass to the big man, 6'10" center. Miles Woods, top of the key. Hands off for Watson, and Watson with the answer at the top of the key. 46-44, and Loyola with a three of their own.
The confidence of Watson to rise up from the top of the key in that spot as Fordham's starting to get momentum says a lot about who that young man is.
Riley, top of the circle, angles his way to the right elbow, gets down low on Greg Dolan, skips it high post. Now he finds Antrell Charlton. Some late pressure there from Braden Norris. Norris and Antrell Charlton, 15-foot fadeaway, no good off the right side of the iron, but the offensive rebound, Elijah Gray, the fade is short. Too much there, and Greg Dolan the other way. A two-point lead for Loyola with the basketball, 46-44. Ramblers kicks left side. Alston, the three-pointer, no good, much too much on the air ball. And Zach Riley loose in the front court, in on Greg Dolan. He'll find Antrell Charlton at the top of the key, attacks the cup from the right side of the lane, dumps it down low for Josh Rivera. Rivera got his shot blocked. Miles Rubin picks up the block there, and Des Watson will have it going the other way. 46-44, Loyola Chicago on top with the basketball. Here's Greg Dolan, the Cornell transfer. Calls out the play, bounces it high post for the center in Miles Rubin. Now down low, Phillip Alston backing his way down, and he's too aggressive. Pushed off from the left block, and the Fordham Rams force another turnover with 11:36 to play. They trail by two, 46-44.
That's the second or third time this afternoon that Alston has made that exact play and committed that exact foul. For as good as he is, it just shows you details matter. Details add up over the course of the game. He essentially just gave Fordham a new lease on life. Rams down two.
And their leading score is a great point. Phillip Alston has looked frustrated all afternoon long. It's a 46-44 lead for Loyola Chicago here on the road. 11:36 to play. But with that, we're going to send it back to our Rose Hill studios for a scoreboard update with Andrew Canary.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Looking across the A-10, the matchup between GW and UMass is in the books, with GW taking the win 81-67. Dayton is dog-walking Rhode Island. The score down in Ohio is 80-53 with 5 minutes left in the second half. Also, Bonnie's and George Mason game just got underway, with George Mason taking the lead 9-5. Elsewhere in college hoops, Houston is taking an early lead against UCF. The score is 8-1 in the first half. Also, the number 2 ranked Purdue Boilermakers are facing some adversity against Iowa in the first half. The score right now is 10-12, Iowa. Later in the afternoon, we have some blockbuster playoff matchups in the NFL. Lamar Jackson's Ravens will take on the C.J. Stroud-led Texans at 4:30 p.m. Also, the Packers will look to keep their momentum against the San Francisco 49ers. That game starts at 8:15. With the one-on-one scoreboard, I'm Andrew Crinieri.
The Ramblers lead here over the Rams. 11:36 to play in the second half. I'm Miles Grossman alongside Colin Loughran. And Colin, this second half has been just about as back and forth as can be, but the Fordham Rams scoreless in the last minute 55, and Loyola Chicago now back on top.
Remember all those nice things we had said about the job Fordham did to begin this game? Yeah, you can throw that out the window at this time in the game. Right now, Loyola Chicago out shooting Fordham from the field in this second half. They're at 70%. Fordham only around 30%. In terms of the battle of the glass, Fordham winning by a slim, and I mean slim, margin, 7-6 to start this second act. Loyola Chicago has essentially allowed Fordham to stay within the game. It hasn't been that Fordham has played a good second half. Loyola Chicago, outside of shooting the ball, has played a sloppy second half in terms of motion and a lot of the mental things that go into winning a basketball game.
And important to mention as well, Colin, that this is might look like a veteran Loyola Chicago team, and it sure is. The average Rambler has 2.59 years of college basketball under their belt on the other side for Fordham, a tick under 2 years. So you can see that experience starting to show for the Ramblers in the second half.
Without the mental errors that the Ramblers have made, this is a much different game, and Loyola Chicago would be leading by a lot more, Miles.
Here's Abdusin Bila at the top of the circle, 11:23 left in the second half. Hands off for the curling Jameer Tripp. He's got it at the free throw stripe. Bounces right side for Ramad Dean. Ramad Dean attacks from the right arc, flips it right side. The extra pass, no good on the right arc three there. Excuse me, left side three for Antrell Charlton. But Loyola, the rebound regardless. They lead 46-44. As Jameer Tripp, far too aggressive, and Braden Norris draws the contact on the floor at the top of the circle. It'll be the near sideline inbound for Loyola Chicago in the offensive half. They lead 46-44, 11:02 to play in the half.
Understandable why Fordham would play such aggressive defense against Braden Norris. He has a team-high 88 assists this season for Loyola Chicago. Surprisingly, he only has 2 assists so far this afternoon.
Here's Jaden Dawson getting harassed by Ramon Dean. Skips it up top for the center, Miles Rubin. Rubin, the waist-high dribble with the right hand, looking back to get it to Dawson on the right arc. He successfully will. Dawson, knee-high dribble. He'll pull up from the distance, and he's no good off the left side of the iron. And Antrell Charlton, the Fordham rebound, ahead to Will Richardson on the outlet pass. Richardson, top of the circle, probes in on Jaden Dawson. Angles his way to the right arc, declines the Abdusin Bila screen, takes it this time, pulls up from three, and he's no good off the back of the heel. But Jameer Tripp, the freshman, the offensive rebound, and he'll kick it right side for Richardson. Richardson drives in, finds Abdu, and Abdu attacking the basket will draw 2 free throws. He got clobbered, and man, I mean, Abdusin Bila, you don't usually see that kind of aggression out of him.
And it was a brave play made by Miles Rubin as well. Abdusin Bila, perhaps a little bit shorter than Rubin, but much more physically built than Rubin. So kudos to Rubin for standing in there as the big man from Cameroon draws the contact.
So Abdusin Bila, 2 points on the day, 1 of 4 from the field, 0 of 0 from the charity stripe. No bend to the knees. The high archer rattles around and down. And Abdu brings Fordham back within a sole point. It's 46-45. Loyola Chicago on top with 10:19 to play in the second half. And Drew Valentine's brand of defense will be put to the test here in the final 10 minutes.
And now if you're Fordham, this is the time in the game where you start to wonder when you're going to see Kyle Rose next.
And Kyle Rose, 3 personal fouls. He's battling some foul trouble. 10 minutes left in the game. Kyle Rose on the bench with 3. Here's Adele Kuhn, top of the circle for Loyola, botting his way into the paint. In on Abdusin Bila, back to the basket. Heart of the circle. Rises with the right hand, and he's much too strong on the fade. Antrell Charlton, the rebound, and he'll cross the timeline at the top of the circle. Kick it left side, Jameer Tripp, the freshman, draws 2 defenders, finds Ramad Dean, left corner, no good on the left corner three, and Greg Dolan rips down the Rambler rebound. 9:42 and ticking. Here's Greg Dolan, attacks from the right side, dumps it down low, Adele Kuhn rises, and he's no good. Once again, too strong, and Jameer Tripp rips it out of his hands following the offensive rebound. Tripp ahead the other way, finds Antrell Charlton. Will Richardson catches the pass and elects to slow things down. 9:24 in ticking in the second half. Loyola Chicago up one. It's 46-45. Charlton at the top of the circle. Bounce pass. Low post entry for Abdusin Bila. Spins around from the right side. Rises and he's no good. Too strong. But Jameer Tripp, another offensive rebound and the putback from the left block. Fordham regains the lead, 47-46.
That's an effort play from Jameer Tripp. That's not about skill. That's about willpower and effort and the will to win. The freshman playing at a high level.
8:55 and ticking, and Adele Kuhn spins around in the low post and draws the contact from Abdusin Bila. This one will be on the floor. And there you have it, Colin Loughran. Abdusin Bila commits the foul. Kyle Rose will now check on for the freshman, Jameer Tripp, with 8:51 to play. And Kyle Rose with 3 fouls. We got to keep an eye on that.
And as soon as Fordham got that lead, I was wondering if we were going to see Kyle Rose come in. You need your best defender out there to help you stave off Loyola Chicago.
Des Watson rises with the left hand over Kyle Rose. He can hit, and Fordham will corral the loose rebound. 8 minutes and 40 seconds to play. Here's Will Richardson at the top of the circle. 47 to 46 is the Ram lead. He'll hand off for the curling Antrell Charlton. Bounce at high post for Kyle Rose, who just checked in his turquoise kicks. Drills behind the back, finds Ramad Dean, top of the key, no good. Off the left side of the iron, and Dawson going for the offensive rebound. Excuse me, the defensive rebound. Charlton rips it free. He'll pop the three, and he cannot hit. Here's Greg Dolan ahead, and he's swatted from behind, but the putback, Jaden Dawson in transition, puts Loyola Chicago back on top, 48-47, 8 minutes flat to play in the second half. Will Richardson to walk it up now, hands off for the curling Antrell Charlton. He'll bounce it at the top of the circle for Kyle Rose. Kyle Rose, the lefty dribble. Greg Dolan applying the pressure. Abdu Sambila offers the screen. Kyle Rose, top of the key, three, no good. Off the back of the heel, and Braden Norris pulls down the Loyola Chicago rebound. 7:37 to play. Drew Valentine wants the timeout, and with a 1-point lead for the Ramblers, 48-47, that will take us to our under eight media timeout. This is Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
How's it going, everybody? I'm Lou Orlando.
And I'm Colin Loughran.
And we're two of your main hosts for WFUV Sports' NHL podcast, 5-on-3.
We'll keep you updated on the Rangers, Islanders, Devils, and of course, the Stanley Cup Final.
Home ice for all things NHL, 5-on-3.
The Fordham Rams scoreless in the last 91 seconds, and Loyola Chicago has retaken the lead 48-47 with 7:36 to play. I'm Miles Grossman. He's Colin Loughran, and we're going to turn now to the third member of our on-site crew, Dan Bartels.
Miles, thank you. Defense is the name of Keith Ergo's game, and when you can show the ability to play defense, you get more opportunities and flexibility on the offensive end. For Jameer Tripp, he leads this Fordham Rams team with 9 points so far. Earlier on in the game, there was a heated exchange between him and Keith Ergo on the bench, criticizing his defense and ability to get up and down the floor. It seems that message has finally sunk in.
Now I hear that, and Jameer Tripp coming off the bench with 9 points, as you said, to lead the Fordham Rams. 3 of 7 from the field, 0-for-2 from range, but what he does best is get to the free throw line, and he's capitalized when he's gotten there today. 3 of 4 on the day for Jameer Tripp from the charity stripe. And while the Fordham Rams are scoreless in the last 90 seconds, I don't want to see any Jameer Tripp's minutes go anywhere.
I think you're at the phase of the game where Fordham's going to start adding points in their head. Who can give you what? Where can they give it to you from? Having Kyle Rose back in the ballgame after having him sit out a little bit due to some foul trouble is critical, because he can hit a three-point shot, he can hit a mid-range shot, he'll drive to the bucket. You can't say as though every other player on this Fordham roster has that same sort of versatility. It's why what you've gotten out of Jameer Tripp and Elijah Gray this afternoon has been so important in the absence of Jafay Madore, who you know will give you 10 points plus per game.
So Loyola Chicago, a narrow lead at our under eight media timeout, 48-47. They lead your Fordham Rams here on Arthur Avenue Day in the Bronx. And as you hear, I believe that's some Italian music, right? That's the theme we're going for there, Colin?
I believe so. Not quite sure, actually, Miles, but it's catchy. It's going to be stuck in my ear now.
Well, we got a lot of Arthur Avenue eats across the street here. Hope you're able to check that out. On the campus of Fordham University, the Michelangelo's advertisement flashes across the scoreboard. 7:30 to play here from Rose Hill Gym. It's 48-47. Loyola Chicago on top with the basketball. Here's Braden Norris. Fakes the two-hand overhead pass, finds Watson top of the key. Gets it back to Norris. He'll heave the three, and the high arcer. Nothing but net for Braden Norris, and a 51-47 lead for Loyola.
Norris with his first points of the game. He was shooting 45% from deep range entering this game. A critical time for his first points.
Josh Rivera backs his way into the lane, flips it up with the right hand. No good, short. Josh Rivera and Elijah Gray both battling for the rebound. It looks like Elijah Gray drew some contact there, Colin. So the possession will stay here with the Fordham Rams. We got another timeout here from Rose Hill Gym. It's 51-47. Loyola Chicago on top by a couple possessions. And we just came out of the under-8 media timeout. And Colin, we got another stoppage here. But Braden Norris, really, that's the bit of action that we just saw to take a four-point lead. He buries the top of the key three. And Braden Norris is a player with loads of Division I experience. He's in his sixth year of college basketball. He did sit one out because he transferred to Loyola Chicago before the transfer portal era, so he still forces it one out, but he's his high school's all-time leading scorer. He won an AAU Peach Jam ring, and now he is a solid, really polished sixth-year A-10 point guard.
Norris is the kind of guy that can hurt you in a variety of ways. He struggled last time out against UMass. That was a game Loyola Chicago won by the skin of their teeth. Norris in that game, 2 of 8 from range, had 6 assists, though. So when the shot's not there for him, he can find ways to facilitate and get his teammates involved. He ended last season with the 26th best career three-point percentage in the nation. So we know he can hit it from deep. It's a question of when does he get those looks. When he gets those looks, can he knock them down? He just made one of the biggest shots in this contest.
And he's part of this Loyola Chicago tradition of postseason success. Keith Thurgo touched on it in our coaches town at the top of the broadcast, but Loyola Chicago is one of 12 teams across Division I men's basketball to have both an NCAA Final Four appearance and an NCAA Sweet 16 appearance in the last 5 tournaments. I mean, that's quite the prestigious thing. I mean, you take a look at who's on that list alongside Loyola Chicago. It's pretty much just them and Blue Bloods.
And that's a huge credit to Coach Drew Valentine over at Loyola Chicago. Over his time there, he has a 124-44 overall record. He's guided teams to the postseason 7 times throughout the course of his career, including 3 NCAA Sweet 16s, 2 of which wound up with trips to the Final Four.
Postseason pedigree, to say the least, Colin. So back underway from Rose Hill Gym. Jameer Tripp at the top of the circle draws contact from Dez Watson coming out of the play. Dez Watson can't believe the call. But it looks like with 6:55 to play in the half, that will bring Jameer Tripp and the Fordham Rams back to the single bonus. So a 1-1 coming up here for the freshman Jameer Tripp. 51-47, the Loyola Chicago lead. Here's Tripp with the right-hand free throw, and he rattles it home to earn an opportunity for one more. He's 4 of 5 from the charity stripe today, and he's got Fordham right back within one possession, 51-48 Ramblers. Tripp spins it into the right palm, rises with the right hand, and he's nothing but net there. Loyola Chicago trails by 2 now, 51-49.
And this is what I mean by counting points. Now you're down 2. Being down 2, different feel to it than being down 3. It's why those free throws begin to add up. They begin to matter more and more as the game wears on.
Braden Norris bounces high post with Phillip Alston, and Alston draws the foul. This one's on the floor. Josh Rivera, the guilty party. And now Loyola Chicago works their way into the single bonus. So it'll be a 1-1 out of the right hand out of the senior forward, Phillip Alston, 14.6 points per game. He's there. Oh, pardon me, the next one will bring them into the bonus. So it's just a far sideline inbound for Loyola Chicago in their road maroons. Here's Braden Norris. He'll bounce it high post for Miles Rubin, the freshman center at 6'10". Knee-high dribble, kicks back. Right outside for Braden Norris. Right arc, Norris. Finds Jaden Dawson, he loses control. He'll have to heave with 2 seconds on the shot clock. He can't hit, but Phillip Alston, the offensive rebound, and he'll restart the possession. He'll find Braden Norris. He'll hand off for Miles Rubin, and the foul. This one's on Jameer Tripp. And now that one, with 6:15 left, should bring Loyola Chicago back into the single bonus here. It's 51-49, Ramblers on top.
And Miles, I know this is not going to show up on the stat sheet tomorrow morning, but the movement that Miles Rubin has been providing on offense for the Ramblers is extraordinary. For a man of his size to be able to move that swiftly, set the screens that he's been able to set this afternoon, certainly impressive.
So Watson is good on the free throw. Make him 4 of 5 so far in the day. He earns an opportunity at one more from the charity stripe with 6 minutes and 15 seconds to play. It's a 52-49 Loyola lead. Here's the free throw, and pure there out of the right hand to Watson. 53-49 now, the Rambler lead, 6-12 and ticking. Will Richardson to walk it up, moving left to right. In on Jaden Dawson. Richardson, top of the key, bounces high post for Jameer Tripp. Tripp back to the basket, spins his way out, hard to the paint. In on Des Watson, he'll rise through two defenders, and he's well short there. Miles Rubin rips down the Loyola rebound, ahead to Braden Norris.
This is a big possession for the Ramblers on offense. If they can hit a three or even get a two here, it changes the tone.
Des Watson finds Braden Norris, top of the circle, takes the Miles Rubin screen. The give and go, Miles Rubin tosses it out of play. And a freshman making a freshman error there. He got caught in the air, and the freshman center needed the outlet. Nobody was home, and the ball dribbles out of play on the near sideline. 5:38 to play in the second half. It's 53-49 Ramblers.
Can you imagine what the score would be without the mental errors that the Ramblers have committed? Fordham with another lease on life here. Still a two-score game.
So here's Will Richardson once again, trots up, hands off for the curling freshman, Jameer Tripp. Tripp, a powerful move, spins into the lane, loses control of the basketball, and he'll have the last touch as it bounces out of play on the offensive baseline of Fordham. And we saw a freshman error out of the right hand of Miles Rubin, and there's a freshman error for Jameer Tripp going right back the Ramblers' way.
And it looked as if Fordham was trying to work quickly on offense. I don't necessarily agree with that decision. It would have been better to set your offense, see what you can figure out half court-wise. Perhaps you get an open three. Perhaps you work a pick and roll towards the basket.
5:24 to play. 53-49, Loyola Chicago on top with the basketball. The fifth-year guard, Braden Norris, on the Fordham Ram logo, spins around on Kyle Rose, angles his way to the left perimeter. Will Richardson switches on to him. Norris bounces it up top for Dame Adele Kuhn, right side mid-post. Back to the basket. He'll kick out right side. Jaden Dawson, the three, too strong off the back of the heel. And Antrell Charlton, the rebound. He'll find Will Richardson, 5 minutes even to play. Fordham Rams trail by four. It's Antrell Charlton on the block F. He'll bounce in high post for Elijah Gray. Gray thought about the three and declined. He'll kick it back up top for Charlton. Hand off on the block F for Will Richardson. Richardson to penetration left side hangs and is blocked from behind. Dame Adele Kuhn, the pressure. And Norris will have it in the backcourt violation. Braden Norris caught it just as he was crossing the timeline, immediately dropped it off for a teammate. And now Des Watson will have a tech. He got into it with Antrell Charlton. And our refs will deliberate. 4:33 to play. Both sides told to head to their respective benches. And now we got the refs at the monitor. And Colin, early in the year, we saw Antrell Charlton get a plethora of technical fouls. It's been a couple weeks, but now it seems back into it with Des Watson. It looked initially like Des Watson will be whistled for the technical, but I would not be surprised to see the double technical.
We spoke about it earlier. Antrell Charlton is the swagger of this Fordham team. He's that kind of cutthroat mentality that you need on your team at times. Listen, it's wonderful to sing Kumbaya and have all of this love and admiration for the opponent, but sometimes you have to be willing to do the dirty work. Antrell Charlton has shown a willingness to do that over the course of his career. You look at games last year against teams like LaSalle and Dayton, it was Antrell Charlton who got an opponent's head with that swagger, with that grit. Fordham needs a little bit of that at this time in the game.
So it was, in fact, the backcourt violation by Braden Norris, and then it's the extracurriculars, Des Watson and Antrell Charlton. The double technical, so neither party will shoot. The technical fouls will cancel out. It'll be Fordham basketball. The near sideline inbound in the offensive half. Kyle Rose flips it in to Will Richardson on the block F. 4:28 and ticking. The Fordham Rams trail by four with the basketball. Richardson takes the Abdu screen, dishes up top. Elijah Gray, three, and he got it. The high archer falls, and the Fordham Rams are right back within one.
Such a gorgeous stroke from Elijah Gray. No hesitation, just rose up and stuck it.
4:09 and ticking. Greg Dolan dribble drive. He dumps it down low, and Dame Adelkun rises through the contact. And they will not get the bucket, but they will get the contact. Two free throws coming for the graduate forward, Dame Adelkun, with 4:06 to play. That'll stop the clock. Already a one-point lead for Loyola Chicago, 53-52, with two more chances coming for Adelkun, and the high archer falls on the front end. 54-52 now, Ramblers lead.
And Miles, the crowd has become a factor in this game now for the first time in what feels like a long time.
So Adelko no good, but Jaden Dawson, the offensive rebound, and the Ramblers keep it right here. Here's Adelkun, the backup big at the top of the circle. Waist-high dribble with the right hand. Angles his way right, hands off for Braden Norris. Braden Norris give and go down low for Adelkun, and a strong finish past the big man and off the glass and in. A 56-52 lead now for Loyola.
Four-point game. Will Richardson now running point for Fordham. We'll see if Charlton gets the rock at some point to do his duty.
Will Richardson. A burst of speed into the lane rises, and it's blocked from behind by Jaden Dawson. An out-of-control look, and Loyola Chicago has it moving the other way. Norris will regroup at the top of the circle, 3:24 and ticking here in the second half. Loyola Chicago a four-point lead in the basketball. Adelkun, the veteran, spins around on Abdu, and the hook falls. A pretty hook reverse there under the basket, and Loyola a 58-52 lead, and Keith Thurgood needs the timeout there with 3:09 to play, and Loyola Chicago a six-point lead and a 5-0 run in the last minute, 08.
The Loyola Chicago bench exploded after that make. They know they're up six now. Completely different feel than a one or two score ball game. Technically, still a two score game before, and we're knocked down two threes. But by all accounts, momentum has shifted towards the Ramblers' favor. And on that last offensive possession in particular, Miles, Will Richardson didn't want to play, didn't have any rhyme or reason. I suggested perhaps this is where Angelo Tarleton would get the ball because he is one of the team's best facilitators. You're without Jafe Madur. Richardson is not at that point yet where you trust him to go rogue like that.
So the Fordham Rams, one for their ass, eight from the field, a 5-0 run for Loyola Chicago. It's a 58-52 lead for the Ramblers on the road. But with 3:09, that will take us to our under 4 media timeout. That will send it back to the Rose Hill Studios for a scoreboard update with Andrew Canary.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
In the A-10, Dayton demolished Rhode Island. The final score in Ohio is 96-62. The St. Bonaventure-George Mason game is heating up with George Mason holding the lead 27-16. St. Joseph's is taking on Duquesne. That game just started and the score is 2-2 with 18 minutes left in the first half. Moving over to the top 25, Houston continues their lead against UCF. The score is 22-11 in the first half. Number 2 ranked Purdue is duking it out with Iowa. The score right now is 33-20 Purdue. Moving up to Boston, UNC is battling with Boston College. The score there is 17-16 with 8 minutes left in the first half. And finally, for your sports entertainment later tonight, the Rangers will take on the Kings at 10:30, the Knicks will battle the Raptors at 7:30, and the UFC is back this year with UFC 297, which features the first title defense of Sean Strickland against rising prospect Dricus du Plessis. With the one-on-one scoreboard, I'm Andrew Crinieri.
Thank you, Andrew, as we welcome you back inside the Rose Hill Gym. It's a 58-52 lead for Loyola Chicago, and the Fordham Rams will look to mount the comeback coming out of the timeout. But before we get back underway in the action, we're going to turn now to Dan Bartels.
Miles, for one last time, thank you. In one of the more recent sequences, Coach Ergo was ecstatic that he had the, quote, three plays held inside 2 seconds of the shot clock. As a team, Loyola continues to lead the A-10 in 17.2 assists per game, good for 24th in the nation. But today, Fordham has held Loyola only 10 assists. If Fordham can continue to stifle Loyola in the passing lanes, we could be in for a really good ending to this one, Miles.
And Loyola Chicago has moved the ball well as late. We'll see if the Fordham Rams
are able to hold their own. So back underway from Rose Hill. Thank you very much for that, Dan. 3 minutes left in regulation. Fordham Rams trail by six. Just Will Richardson dribble drive, and he's swatted. Adele Kuhn, the big man down low, sends it right back where it came from. And Loyola Chicago and Braden Norris come up with the rebound. 2:42 and ticking. Here's Adele Kuhn at the top of the circle. One-on-one on the sophomore, Elijah Gray. Dame Adele Kuhn back to the basket. Kicks it up top for Jaden Dawson. Back to Adele Kuhn, left side short corner. Once again, backing his way into the lane on the sophomore, Elijah Gray. Adele Kuhn has it blocked. Standing tall over the top there is Elijah Gray, and Fordham the other way.
It was a hell of a stop by Elijah Gray. Just got his hands up there, didn't foul. Incredibly challenging given where Adelkin was.
58-52, Ramblers on top. Here's Rivera at the top of the circle. 2:07 to play. Will Richardson wide open, right arc, and he will nail it in the contact. Fordham right back within a sole possession. 2:04 to play, and Will Richardson an opportunity for a four-point play.
Richardson with a redemptive bucket. He's had a couple of hard misses in this ballgame, a couple of looks that didn't quite go his way. Now has a chance to change tide back into Fordham's favor.
And Will Richardson, a couple of iffy moves earlier in this second half, but the shot of the day so far for the Fordham Rams, and he nails the free throw. A four-point play for the sophomore at Teaneck, New Jersey, and with 2 minutes to play, the Fordham Rams are within two. 58-56, Braden Norris skips it high post for Jaden Dawson, and Loyola Chicago will need the timeout. Head coach Drew Valentine wants them to head to the bench, and that's what they'll do. A minute 57 to play from Rose Hill, and the Fordham Rams are right back within just two.
That is a veteran timeout from Drew Valentine. Very tactful on his part. He knows the stakes of this game. He knows that he doesn't want his guys overthinking anything on the offensive side of the ball. Better to set, better to figure out what your game plan is going to be. As far as Loyola Chicago is concerned, they have a proficiency when it comes to trying to work towards the paint. But if a three is there, if someone like Braden Norris is wide open, do you give him the green light in that situation? These are the kind of conversations they are surely having up too late.
Loyola Chicago, known for their affiliation with Sister Jean. She's known as their good luck charm around the program. She's 104 years old now. She rose to fame throughout their couple of NCAA tournament runs. They'll need a little luck from her here down the stretch.
A little bit of faith as well. Never hurts anyone as far as these Jesuit institutions
exactly
are concerned.
Right. So 1:57 a play. It's Loyola Rambler basketball. And they lead by two, 58-56. Here's the veteran point guard, Braden Norris. On the Fordham Ram logo, getting harassed by Kyle Rose. Braden Norris bounces it left arc for Jaden Dawson. Dawson angles his way to the A-10 logo, skips it right side for Philip Alston. Alston driving kick into the hands of Will Richardson. Fordham Rams pick it off, trailing by two. Here's Richardson, right arc transition, triple, no good. Just short there, and Brendan Norris, the rebound for Loyola Chicago.
So close. Will Richardson was so close to giving Fordham a lead. Just a little short on the jumper, didn't finish it all the way through.
Minute 20 to play. Here's Des Watson at the top of the circle. He'll pull the jumper, and the three-pointer is pure. Des Watson makes it a 61-56 lead for Loyola. 1:06 to play, and Will Richardson now to walk it up for Fordham. Richardson finds Rose on the block F. The extra pass to Antrell Charlton. Charlton top of the circle, dribbles behind the back on Des Watson. Up top, Elijah Gray fakes the three. Once again, dribbles behind the back. Some penetration. He'll pull from 10 feet, and he'll rattle home the elbow jumper there. And the Fordham Rams are within three, and Keith Urgo wants the timeout. 48.2 seconds to play. Loyola Chicago, a three-point lead. It'll be their ball coming out of the timeout.
What a mid-2000s look from Elijah Gray. Off the dribble from the mid-range. It's not often you see a big man try and pull that type of shot, but good on him to keep the dribble, keep composed, and hit the shot.
And Elijah Gray, a sophomore, but he's got moves well beyond his years, and that's why he's been such a reliable part of the Fordham attack. I mean, mentally, you can tell he holds himself to a high standard. When he gets frustrated with himself, he makes it obvious to everybody. But that's one of the things Keith Urgel loves most about him, that he's a sophomore. He's got such a high ceiling. He's so talented, and he holds himself to the high standard. Well, he hits a tough fadeaway there, and I wouldn't be surprised if they keep the ball in his hands down the stretch.
Elijah Gray did not start this ball game. Has come off the bench in 16 minutes, 5 of 9 from the field. He's been very good in terms of scoring the basketball as well, 12 points on the day. There are some that would argue he should have started in place of Romad Dean as far as this game's concerned.
Absolutely.
It's worth wondering what would have happened had Gray started out of the gate with his offensive proficiency. That's not to say that Dean is a bad offensive player, but they are different offensive players at this time in their careers.
And Elijah Gray, the leading scorer now for those Fordham Rams, up to 12 points on the afternoon, 5 of 9 from the field, and 2 of 2 from three-point range. Looking outside of him on that Fordham box score, it's Will Richardson up to 11 points on 2 of 6 from range. And then Jameer Tripp off the bench with his own 11, 3 of 8 from the field. Those are the three for the Fordham Rams in the absence of Jafay Madore, their leading scorer, who's averaged 16.6 over the last 5 games. And the Fordham Rams trailing by 3, under a minute to play now. And Loyola will inbound. Here's Greg Dolan into the point guard, Brendan Norris. The two-man pressure from Kyle Rose and Will Richardson. Norris will cross the timeline on the near side, flip it ahead to Greg Dolan. 36 seconds on the game clock, 17 seconds on the shot clock. Greg Dolan, the graduate guard, the Cornell transfer at the top of the circle, bounces high post for Dame Adelkun. Dame Adelkun spinning around on Gray, works his way into the lane, and the jump ball forced, but the shot clock with 5 seconds, and it'll keep it right here on the jump ball forced. The possession arrow says Loyola Chicago. So with 5 seconds on the shot clock, the Ramblers will have another possession. It'll be the baseline inbound in the offensive half. 23.2 seconds to play. 5 seconds on the shot clock.
I would watch Norris very carefully. He's very good with the basketball. He keeps it low, almost a Bob Cousy-like dribble. You want to tip it away if the pass is a little bit high. Don't let him bring that ball down to his comfort zone.
And this Loyola offensive possession is right in front of that Fordham student section, who is on their feet now. Des Watson flips it high post, and Antrell Charlton going for the steal, commits the contact, and Dame Adelkun will be headed back to the free throw line. 61 to 58 is the Loyola Chicago lead, and Dame Adelkun will have a chance for two more free throws with 22.7 seconds left in regulation. The shot clock is off.
Adelkun, no stranger to the spotlight, a Dartmouth transfer, made second team all Ivy last year, averaging just about 13 points per game. He embraces moments like this, Miles.
So Dame Adelkun is good on the first of two, making a 62 to 58 Loyola Chicago lead. 22.7 seconds to play. Here's one more out of the right hand of Adelkun, and he's money there. 63 to 58. And the Fordham Rams trail by 2 possessions with the shot clock off at Rose here. Hills Will Richardson to cross the timeline. On the block F, Richardson a burst of speed. Flips it high post. Elijah Gray the triple, and he got it. Fordham within 2, 63 to 61, 14 seconds to play. And the Fordham Rams will whistle for the timeout. Loyola Chicago will have the basketball coming out of the break, but it's going to become a must-foul situation if the Fordham Rams can't force the turnover.
Elijah Gray once again with a pivotal shot, and the look of calm on the Fordham players' faces after they made that made shot is something to behold, Miles. Typically, when you hit a shot of that magnitude, you see guys are pumped up, slapping fives, doing X, Y, Z. They just all move towards the huddle, getting ready to defend here. If they can force a turnover, then it becomes about what can you do at the other end. Do you look for a two if you have it to tie this one up? If you have a three, do you dare shoot it? You have to start planning those X's and O's out right here, right now.
Well, it's all about if the Fordham Rams are able to force that initial turnover. If they are, they'll be sitting pretty. But if not, they're going to need to commit the pretty immediate foul. The Fordham Rams are known for their full court pressure. It's what they do best. They're going to need to force another turnover in this full court pressure set.
And with Dolan inbounding, you know that there's only a handful of guys on the court for Loyola Chicago that they're comfortable with handing the basketball. Norris, one of them. Alston, perhaps one of them. Excuse me, that would be Watson.
So Greg Dolan inbounds to Des Watson, ahead to Adele Kuhn, fouled on the floor by Antrell Charlton. So that'll stop the clock with 9.8 seconds, but there you have it. Loyola Chicago did successfully beat the full court pressure, earned the contact, and Dame Adele Kuhn will be the name headed back to the free throw line with 9.8 seconds to play. It's a 63-61 Loyola lead. Two more chances for the graduate forward coming off the bench.
This was the best possible person to foul of the people out there. It wasn't ideal, but it was the best of a set of bad outcomes.
And the high arcer there for Adele Kuhn is nothing but net. Didn't touch an ounce of rim there. And it's a 64-61 lead for Loyola. 9.8 seconds to play. And one more free throw out of the right hand of Adele Kuhn, and he rattles it home. A 65-61 lead now for Loyola, 9.8 seconds to play. And the Fordham Rams will have to push ahead. Here's where Richardson, he crossed the timeline, 6 seconds to play. Richardson, left corner, finds Antrell Charlton, left arc three. No good, short there. Tipped out to Zach Riley, and the shot clock and the game clock expires. 65-61, the Loyola Chicago Ramblers make the trip east to Rose Hill and down the Fordham Rams on their home court. The Fordham Rams will now move to 8-10 on the year, 2-3 in Atlantic 10 play. And Colin, not the result the Fordham Rams were looking for, but there were some moments early in this game you saw some flashes of exactly what you were looking for down the stretch in Atlantic 10 play.
Certainly not the result Fordham wanted, as you said, Miles. Fordham had a lead at halftime at this one. They led 34-30. Had a lead at halftime against Davidson as well. You begin to wonder if these are the kinds of games that a more mature team would close out and win. I feel like we've said it a number of times about this Fordham team where there's a lot to like, but they haven't been able to seal the deal in some of these contests, and you begin to assume that these players will grow into their own and that will ultimately change the results, but that's not giving much solace to a fan base that's ready to win right now, especially after last year's heroics being what they were.
So a disappointing home stretch here for the Fordham Rams. Of course, they got pretty hot on the road in Atlantic 10 play, but now they return home. And they fall now to Loyola Chicago here at this Saturday afternoon contest. And it doesn't look like we're going to be joined by anyone on the Fordham men's basketball staff this afternoon. So, Colin, why don't we just take the authority and wrap this one up ourselves. The Loyola Chicago squad was awfully solid today, but they do come in and they take down the Fordham Rams on their home court, and obviously, given the crowd here, this is not what they wanted to see.
To Fordham's credit, they did a nice job of slowing down Philip Alston. He only had 6 points today. Ultimately, though, the Ramblers were aided by three men. Des Watson, Jaden Dawson, and Dame Adelkin all had double-figure scoring afternoons. Des Watson, the leader of the bunch, with 19 points, 6 of 10 from the field, 5 of 6 from the charity stripe. Free throws began to add up for Fordham as well. They went 13 of 18 from the free throw line. How big of a difference would that have made down the stretch had you hit your free throws?
And not only make them, but one thing that I did love about the Fordham Rams game today is the first half ability to get to the free throw line. That's something they were one of the worst teams in the nation at coming in today, just earning trips to the free throw line. They did it pretty well in the first half, but they got away from it in the second half.
11 attempts in the first half, 7 attempts in the second half, and that's something that Keith Urgo preached heading in that they have to be consistent on. Well, he didn't do it in the final 20.
And they certainly missed Jaffe Madur in that
regard.
He's their main ball handler. He's able to find spaces that other guys just can't, and with that comes an ability to draw contact and get to the line. I would suppose that's a silver lining that Fordham fans should be able to take away from this one, is that they competed against this Loyola Chicago team without their leading scorer on the season. You can wonder what it would have been like had Jaffe Madur been able to play. They're going to need him down the stretch of this season if they're still intent on making a run.
So Jaffe Madur, 16.6 points over his last five games. He turns his ankle against Davidson, does not play today, and the Fordham Rams fall at home to Loyola Chicago 65-61, and they won't be at home next until 1:31 against Richmond. A couple of road contests coming up for the Fordham Rams. We'll have those covered for you for WFUV Sports. Rhode Island coming up next. That's a Wednesday matchup on the road in Kingston. And then this Saturday, they travel to Pittsburgh to face Duquesne. But the Fordham Rams fall to 8-10 on the campaign, 2-3 in Atlantic 10 play. On the other side for Loyola, they move to 13-6 overall, an amazing 5-1 start to Atlantic 10 play. And Colin, this is a Loyola team that won just 4 games in Atlantic 10 play last year.
And they're a lot like Fordham was last season. They have a two-headed monster that consistently scores the basketball for them. They feel like they were undervalued when it comes to the preseason polls, and they do feel as though they can make a run at winning an A-10 title and perhaps going to March to dance with the Blue Bloods once again.
And they seem to have the experience to do so, but that will do it from us inside Rose Hill Gym. From Griffin Stevenson, our on-site producer, Dan Bartels, our sideline reporter, he's been Colin Loughran, I've been Miles Grossman, saying so long, and thank you for spending part of your Saturday afternoon with us. And with that, we'll send it back to our Rose Hill Studios just across the street for the post-game show with Chris Carrino and Andrew Canary.
The one-on-one post-game report.
Welcome back to the Rose Hill Campus Studio. Rams fall short 65-61 to the Loyola Chicago Ramblers this Saturday afternoon at the historic Rose Hill Gym. I'm joined once again by the one and only Andrew Canary. Andrew, disappointing one this afternoon.
Yeah, no, definitely disappointing, and I mean, I hate to say it, but the proof is in the pudding. The proof is in the numbers. I mean, just look at the field goal percentage. Fordham shooting at 36.2%, 21 for 58. I mean, it's very clear how the Fordham team lost the second half and ended up losing the game.
Yeah, we talked at halftime kind of the importance of guys like Elijah Gray. You brought him up. He led the team in points for the game. And this Fordham team, we were wondering throughout the game, Andrew, we were talking to each other, why is this team losing? Why are they losing ground on this Loyola Chicago team? They're not turning the ball over an insane amount. They're getting offensive rebounds. They're getting second chances. What is wrong? And then you look at field goal and three-point percentage, and that tells most of the story.
Yeah, no, definitely. I mean, when I was kind of preparing for this post-game, you know, report, I was looking throughout the numbers, you know, turnovers, rebounds. Nothing was really amiss, and I was like, wow, why is this game as competitive and as close as it is? And why is Fordham losing? And like you said, I mean, just the proof is in, you know, the field goal percentage and also just 3 points as well. I mean, Fordham threw, I think, double the amount of three-pointers that Loyola Chicago did and only landed 2 more.
Yeah, and some of the positives for this Fordham team, you look at offensive rebounds. They out-rebounded them on the offensive glass 13-8. That means second chances. That means more shots. That means more opportunities that could have been taken advantage of. The defensive rebounds is definitely in the favor of Loyola Chicago, but I think the story really starts and ends when it comes to the field goal percentage and three-point percentage. We talked about the three-point kind of aspect of both teams' game at halftime. Loyola Chicago wasn't taking that many, and Fordham really wasn't shooting them very well. And for the game, Fordham shooting 6 for 20 from the three-point line, really hard to win a game that way.
Yeah, no, definitely. I mean, it's extremely hard to win a game that way. And also mixed in just with the other problems that they had throughout this game, it just seemed overall in the second half that they just, it kind of continued the theme of the end of the first half, that they were slowing down and weren't as consistent as that hot start that we saw at the very beginning of the game.
Yeah, this Fordham team, Andrew, had a 12-point lead at one point. That kind of game you just can't let get away.
Yeah, no, you can't. But I will say I do want to highlight some of the Loyola Chicago players that really, you know, made this game competitive and kind of, you know, won it back. They were able to claw back and, you know, secure the win. You know, guys like Des Watson and Jaden Dawson. I mean, as, you know, our color commentator said, Colin, both those guys in double digits in terms of points scored, they tangibly changed the outcome of this game.
Mm-hmm. Right, and on the other side, for Fordham, they had 25 minutes with a lead in this game, Andrew. They had 63% of the game. They had a lead at one point. It's disappointing, not only just for today, but the circumstances around today's game. This felt like a very important game for the Fordham Rams, and they just couldn't get it done.
Yeah, no, I mean, this game was extremely important in terms of how this team is going to play when they come home, because we've seen that they have been strong in away games in the past, but every single time it seems in recent history that this team comes home, they have some pretty crushing and, you know, frankly, quite embarrassing losses. So I feel like unless if they kind of change this momentum, it's going to continue to be this way.
And Andrew, kind of looking ahead, if Fordham has a similar problem to this where they just kind of get cold from the field and they aren't seeing shots going in, what could they do in another field to compensate for maybe that, you know, that low amount of percentage in the field goals and 3-point?
I mean, I think it's kind of what Keith Ergo said, is that they have to play some really gritty defensive-minded basketball and force the other team to make, you know, dumb mistakes that can lead to easy opportunities for the Fordham team. I think that's what we saw early on in this game and led to, you know, them taking the lead early on. But as we saw, as that game progressed, it just kind of, you know, dried up.
That's it for us here in the Rose Hill Campus Studio. Rams fall short 65-61 to the Loyola Chicago Ramblers. Of course, I was joined by Andrew Canary on updates. Our producer is Owen Kelty. Supervising producer is Julia Moss. Engineer on highlights is Gabby Price. Our sports director is, of course, Bobby Chaffardini. I'm Chris Carrino, hoping everyone has a great rest of their weekend. Fordham Men's Basketball is a production of WFUV Sports.